Riga gaga dan chala gala prakusse chali gala chala gala prakusse chali raga gaga dan chala gala prakusse chali gala chala gala prakusse chaya riga gaga dan chala gala prakusse chali gala chala gala prakusse riga gaga dan chala gala prakusse chala gala prakusse gaga riga gaga dan chala gala prakusse chala gala prakusse gaga ah gala prakusse chali gala chala gala prakusse gaga riga gaga dan chala gala Father, you are worthy, you are mighty, you are faithful. Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Shalom, Jehovah Elohim, Makusu Taragali Bragayatea. Blessed be your name, Lord. I will lift my voice and I will sing. I will sing holy. My God and King, I will sing holy, I will sing holy, I will praise the Lamb of God who sits upon the throne, I will worship Him.
I'll sing a love song.
Sisters, family, friends, children, you are all welcome in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Tell God this is a prayer call. Lord has called us for prayer, and God is going to help us to pray.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So how is your race? I am running, running and running and running and running and running to meet my Redeemer. I will meet him in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
By the grace of God, family, today, by the mercy of God, is a special day for Bible believers.
Amen.
So we are announcing it before time. If you are not a Bible believer, you don't want to believe the Bible, you feel it is a history book, it's a literature book, you will not enjoy today's prayer call. For today, especially for all Bible believers, God Almighty is calling us to His Word, which we call the Bible, the Holy Scriptures. So by the grace of God, it's an opportunity for us to call somebody who is doubting the Scripture, who is doubting the Bible. It's time for the person to know that the Bible is the Word of God. Amen. The Lord is going to help us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And what is your oxygen? Prayer! Pray. Open your mouth and pray. The devil will not finish us with quietness. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Child of God, after death, no prayer. Nobody can pray after death. And that is why when people are in a sick bed, the first the devil does is close their mouth. They can't talk. They're going to, they cannot talk. Why? You had an opportunity to talk when you were alive, when you were healthy. You didn't talk. You did not pray. You were keeping your mouth mum. God Almighty said, it's time to open our mouth and pray.
Amen.
And He's going to help us.
Amen.
Because that is the greatest problem of Christians today is prayer. You can talk, you can chat, you can do everything, but not pray. No prayer. Prayer is time, thinking time. Prayer is time of mind. People say they are praying in their mind. Child of God, God Almighty say, when you pray, say. When you pray, say. Say this open mouth. I have a burden in my heart because God Almighty said many of my children, they don't want to pray. But they want benefit of prayer. They want blessing. They want power. Yeah, they want anointing. Yeah, they want to heal the sick. Without prayer, it's not possible. That's the good news for us.
Amen.
So we are going to be trained in the place of prayer.
Amen.
We're not going to be nodding head at God. We're not nodding head. We're not lizards. We are made in God's image.
Amen.
And yet the first thing that God did in the book of Genesis 1:1 is, and God said, which we are going to see.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Don't be deceived though that one pastor is praying for you somewhere. It's a lie. Nobody pray for you. You are to pray for yourself. Stand with God on your own. And God Almighty is not going to allow the devil to steal it from us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I will say, family, I am planting in holiness. With who? With God and God alone. God and God alone. God and God alone. That is my watchword. God and God. Look at me in the book of Isaiah 44 verse number 8. The Lord said, if you're a Bible believer, look at it. I am one God. I am not Trinity. Child of God, beware of Trinity. You will get lost. You'll be looking for three gods. You will not understand it. This is a teaching that you have to know. What does it say?
Isaiah 44 verse 8.
Uh-huh.
Fear ye not, neither be afraid.
Yes.
As what I told thee from that time, I have declared it, ye are even my witnesses. Is there a God beside me?
No.
Yea, there is no God.
No.
I know not any.
Hallelujah. There is no God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost. Child of God, it is one God.
One God.
Is God the Father that entered into His Son, who He needed blood from. to cleanse you and I, Makoso Taria, and he is called the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
He's not a dove, he's not a bird, Makoso Taragaya. The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of the living God. Just like you have the human spirit, you have the evil spirit. God Almighty, his own spirit is called the Holy Spirit. And his name is Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God Almighty said, this is a teaching of the Spirit. It's for Bible believers. It's for those that submit themselves for the Lord God Almighty to open their eyes of understanding, to understand the scripture. So I will not go into error. Child of God, God Almighty is calling us to truth. The time is running. You can see time is running fast. Things are happening fast. In any time for us to be in ignorance, don't struggle with these three God things. Drop religion. Pick one God. The one that says, when you pray, say, our Father. Our Father. He knows what he is saying. God Almighty is calling us to truth.
Amen.
And we are going to receive it today.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
By the grace of God, we are still pressing on. This is the month of November. We do not know yet if the Lord has a prayer call specially for us. So we are going to be occupying with what we have as our schedule until the Lord directs us. We're not going to preempt the Lord. So on Friday, Jesus time, we have questions and answers again with the scriptures. We already have about one or two questions that are very, very strong. If Jesus tarries, they will be answered on Friday and any other question that you may have. So go ahead and prepare yourself in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And I cannot forget the water baptism. Child of God, water baptism is very, very necessary. Do not allow anybody to deceive you. If you pray and seek God, God Almighty will tell you that you should be baptized. And it should be in the name of Jesus Christ. If I've been baptized before, in the name of titles, you have to go back to the water and get it right. The most important thing is that you have now known that it is not three gods. It's not to be baptized in titles. It's in the book of Acts chapter 2 verse 38. The first church. The first people that spoke in tongues. The first people that received the Holy Ghost. The first people that died in prayer, waiting upon the Lord until the Lord came in his might, in his power, in his glory, and sat on everybody. So nobody, no argument. Nobody argued it because everybody received the portion of the Holy Ghost. So what does he say in Acts 38?
Then Peter said unto them, repent.
After preaching, Peter screamed to repent because they requested to know how to be saved.
Yes. And be baptized.
And then be baptized.
Every one of you in the name of Jesus.
Everybody that repents must go through baptism in the name
of Jesus.
Of Jesus Christ.
For the remission of sins.
For the remission of sins.
And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
And then we shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. You can have the gift before the baptism. God is the one that gave it to himself. As him to you, he wants to be gracious unto. So if the Lord sees that you are ready, you are genuinely repented, you are seeking him, you want to serve him, he can give you the Holy Ghost. Before getting the baptism, it happened to me. I got the Holy Ghost if I was baptized right. So God can do it. It is his own prerequisite. It is his own power and jurisdiction. It is his spirit. He can give to whoever he wants to give. So God Almighty is telling us that baptism is important. Not before repentance. So if you are baptized as a child or when you are living in sin, it's not a void. Baptism that is recognized is the one that you have repented of your sin. You have denied sin. You have denied the world. You have denied the devil. So you go and do a physical representation of your faith belief. By going into the water, which represents the word of God, I'm dying with Jesus. And coming up again in resurrection and then standing to serve God. That's the baptism. The Lord God Almighty will make a way for us.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
By the grace of God, today we are going to go into another time of the word and then to pray the word of God.
Amen.
We want to minister a song to the Lord to tell him how important his word is. How important the Bible is to us. B-I-B-L-E. Basic instructions before leaving earth. Child of God, God Almighty said, the Bible is our treasure. So his word, according to Psalm 119, look for this scripture. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet. Look for it. Psalm 119 verse 105. Read it before we sing it. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. God's word is what guides us here, not forecasters, not what the world is saying, not globalists. God's word is our direction.
Amen.
But as you see, Psalm 119, verse 105.
Psalm 119, thy word is a lamp unto my feet.
God's word is a lamp unto our feet.
And a light unto my path.
And a light unto our path. Remember the lamp? Remember the lamp about the wise, the virgins? Child of God, God Almighty is calling us to go to his word. So that we will have lights to move in our narrow path. Our path is narrow. But not only Broadway. Broadway people, they don't need lights. We need lights. And the light is God's word. God Almighty is calling us to return to the Bible. Child of God, by the time we finish the word today, you will see the need to go back to the Bible. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, feel I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I feel as long as you are here. Please be near me to the say, Lord, thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and pray. Lord God Almighty, Lord, your word is everything to me. Your word is everything to me. stand, O Lord, with your word. Jesus Christ's mighty name, we help you
read. Amen.
Our daddy God, we give you praise, we worship you, Lord. We magnify your name. What a mighty Father you are. What an excellent daddy you are. Oh, glory be to your holy name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for bringing us again, O Lord, on your feet, O God. To learn, O Lord, from you, our Rabboni, our Rabbi. Lord God Almighty, we bow to you, Lord, in your mercy, Lord. We pray that, Lord God Almighty, you'll have mercy on us, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. Anywhere you find any stain or sin in our lives, O God, Lord, let your blood wash us clean, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord God Almighty, we pray that, Lord, we have come, we will not go back the same, O God. We will not leave your presence the same, O God. Lord, your word shall light upon us and will never be ashamed. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, touch your son there, touch your daughter, touch that child over there, touch your entire family so that are gathering unto you, Lord. Let it be a time, O Lord, of impartation of your truth. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord God Almighty, sit upon me, Lord. Rest yourself on me, wrap yourself around me, Lord. Let no man see me, but let all men see you, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, let I make yourself known and real to every one of us, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, open the eyes of our understanding, O God Almighty, to understand, O Lord, the scriptures, Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, take over the networks, Father. Take over the airwaves, Lord. Take over, Lord, all the connections, Father. Let everything, O Lord, work for your glory. Lord, sit on the console, O Lord, of this Facebook, O Lord. And let everything, O Lord, bow to you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, sweet Heavenly Father. We love you forever, Lord. We honor you, Lord. We celebrate you, Lord. It's all about you, not ourselves, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ. As you prepare us for your coming, Lord, help us, Lord God Almighty, Father, Lord, to be expectant, O Lord, that our eyes will be off this world, O Lord. Our eyes will be on the sky. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, sweet daddy. We appreciate you forevermore. Glory, glory, glory be to your name. Hallelujah to your name, Dad. In Jesus Christ's unchallengeable name, we have prayed. Amen. And amen. Hallelujah. Family, I don't know about it, but I love prayer. So some people don't like it. So when we are there around me, we have issues because they don't want prayer. They want short prayer. We have a Zoom prayer consult here. It's 2.5 hours. Only those that love prayer can come there. Some people have learned, they say it's too long. Can't it be 1 hour or less? Hey, Kalata, yeah. I say we have 24 hours. The Bible said every day, hour there is devil. Sufficient of the evil, there's a devil. So read it. Read Matthew 6:34. Every day has devil.
Yes.
And it is not a matter of 1 hour in the day. It's 24 hours. What does it say, Matthew 6:34?
Take therefore no thought for the morrow.
Not say it tomorrow alone.
For the morrow shall take thought for the things of itself.
Uh-huh.
Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof.
You don't say there's a sufficient problem for the day. Marcus, it's a sufficient problem for every day. You don't just wake up and think that you can go through the day without God. Child of God, we need prayer.
Yes.
That's why God comes every morning with mercy. Bible says every morning God comes with mercy. Every morning you wake up, there's mercy to greet you. It's the mercy of God that we're not consumed. Bible also says that every day God comes with benefits. Look at it in Psalm 68. Look at Psalm 68, verse number 19, because somebody needs to know that today is a special day.
Hallelujah. Blessed be the Lord.
Blessed be the Lord.
Who daily loaded us with benefits.
Somebody say load.
Load.
Ah, kalebo kusuta nagaya. You see, he daily loaded us
with benefits.
With benefits. Benefits of joy, of peace, of strength, of favor, of power, of grace to pray.
Yes, amen.
God cannot tell you to pray and there is no grace. So one of the benefits that he gives to us every day, is it a daily thing or once in a while?
Daily.
It's daily. One of the things he does is give us grace to pray.
Amen.
Grace to read his word. Tell God, God loves fellowship. God loves us to be close to him.
Yes,
and if there's anything that God does so well, is give us grace to remember him.
Amen.
Is give us grace to do things to him, to come close to him. That is why I am excited.
Hallelujah.
So bear with me. If I am too excited about him, I don't know how to pass some to you. Sometimes I wish I can carry somebody and let me share this joy I have with you, the joy of the Lord, the one that makes us to want to please God, the one that makes us to have the reverential fear for God. Child of God, if you genuinely love God, if you're excited about God, you will not want to hurt him. You don't want to offend him. You want him to always be happy with you. That is true. That is what they call love. That is love, not like fake love. Love. Love is wanting somebody to be comfortable around you by obeying them. That's God's definition of love. We'll put it in the book of John. John chapter number 15. Look at it. Verse 14. John 15, verse 14.
John chapter 15, verse 14.
Uh-huh.
Ye are my friends if you do whatsoever I command you.
The Lord said, you are my friends if it was whatever I command you. But that said, if you love me, keep my commandment. Look for the verse 14, 15. That's the other way around. Makosu there. He said, if you love me.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
John 14, verse 15.
Uh-huh.
If you love me.
If you love me.
Keep my commandments.
Obey me.
Amen.
Keep my commandments. Make it serious. Don't be casual. Don't say God understands. Make it deliberate. That's a sign of love. So when you find yourself when you're having issues with people that you love, check it. Somebody's not doing something right. Error produces friction. Error produces trouble. When marriages are breaking, there's error. If we can deal with that error, child of God, there will be love in the home. There will be free flow. You will not have fights, and then you are going to have progress. Child of God, progress comes in the midst of love and understanding. Satan cannot enter there. The Bible says what? A house that is divided against itself cannot stand. That's what the Lord said by himself. And that's when Judas is kind of ready to go. He said, go quickly. Leave this place. Why? These 11, they understand. They are going to be together. Child of God, beware of friction in your home, in your business, even in your life. Don't be confused. Don't become Trinity. Don't put body aside, soul apart, spirits aside. Blend yourself in. Sit down like David and learn to talk to your soul. When your soul is misbehaving, call it to order. Don't allow your soul to walk away. Don't allow your body to move your soul to go and do error. Bring it together and be under one umbrella with God. The Lord will deliver us from the spirit of human trinity.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Today, the Lord God Almighty said, it's a day for Bible believers.
Yes, sir.
The topic is a question. Are you truly a Bible believer? Are you truly a Bible believer? Child of God, Jesus Christ did not come to call a gathering of Christianity. He never used the word Christian while he was here. He never used that word. Go to the scripture. He never used Christian in the mouth of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because that's not why he came. He came for a purpose. He came for an assignment. He came to deliver us from the power of sin. So that we will believe. John 3:16. That's why he came. Look at John 3:16.
For God so loved the world.
For God so loved the world.
That he gave his only begotten son.
That he gave his only begotten son.
That whosoever believeth in him should not perish.
That whosoever come for utter God.
Whosoever believeth in him.
Whosoever join church.
Whosoever believeth in him.
Whosoever become a Christian.
Whosoever believeth in him.
Jesus Christ came for believers.
Mm-hmm.
Whosoever believeth in him.
Should not perish but have everlasting life.
Should not perish but have everlasting life. And this belief is not an ordinary belief, because God is going to take us deep into what belief is.
Amen.
And if we don't finish today, if Jesus tells us, we'll continue, child of God. We don't rush important issues. This is the purpose why Jesus came. To raise believers. Let's look more scriptures about it, son. Look at the book of John, chapter 14, verse 1. Write them down. Matthew 9, 28. Look at John 16, 31. John 14, 1. Matthew 9, 28. John 16, 31. Matthew 21, 22. John 11, 40. Let's read this, I believe, 5 verses. Let's read them.
John chapter 14, verse 8.
Okay.
Verse 1.
John chapter 14, verse number 1.
Let not your heart be troubled.
Let not your heart be troubled. These are words of Jesus Christ.
Ye believe in God.
Ye believe in God.
Believe also in me.
Believe also in me, because both of them are one. According to John 10:30. John 10:30 says, he and the Father, they are one. So when you have seen him, you have seen the Father. Child of God, Jesus Christ is the only language that God can use to explain to humanity who he is.
Hallelujah.
He is the image of God. He is the language that God used, so that when you see him, you understand God's language. Because God is a spirit. We cannot see God. The day we see God, we die. Until we are changed to immortality like him, then we will see him as he is. Hallelujah. I will not miss that day.
That
is why I'm striving. So God Almighty is calling us to know that once we have seen Jesus, whatever he says, whatever he does, it is him that is sending him. He is the one that you are seeing, manifesting in flesh. Read on.
Matthew chapter 9, verse 28.
What does he say?
And when he was coming to the house, the blind man came to him. And Jesus said unto them, believe ye that I am able to do this? He said unto him, yea, Lord.
Amen.
God, yea, Lord. Hallelujah. Child of God, God Almighty is after belief. Say, do you believe? Once you believe, you are a believer. He who serves is a servant. God is calling us to believe. Believe him. Believe his word. Believe what he can do. Believe everything about him. There's a package of believing. You don't tell me, I believe you are my mother, but you don't believe the words. Child of God, word is somebody. Somebody's word is the person. Keeping your word makes you who you are. It's a package of you. So beware of saying, I didn't mean it. That's not what I meant. You have said it, and we cannot deny Jesus. He said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. So don't talk, don't be rash to speak that you regret. I didn't mean it. Child of God, you will not be believed. The smallest lie is enough to kill the biggest trust. That's why people are having heartbreaking marriages. They believe that this woman can never do this. They realize their husband can never do this. So a little distrust, a little lie will kill all the big trusts you had for that spouse, for that husband, or that wife. So God Almighty is after 100% belief in him, his word, and all that he represents. What's the next verse?
John chapter 16, verse
31. John 16:31. Son, receive grace in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Jesus answered them.
Yes.
Do you now believe?
Do you now believe? Because you didn't believe before. So he keeps coming to, do you now believe? If it is our time now, the person will become worker in the church. They will make the person minister. Many preachers don't believe God. That's when they go to the devil to get power. God Almighty is calling us to believe, and he will keep coming to investigate, because you don't know when you become an unbeliever. So that's why you cannot say the God of so person, because you don't know when they have disbelieved, when they have left. See, do you now believe? That means he has asked him before, he did not. So now, do you believe? God Almighty said he's after believers. I am a believer.
I am a believer.
I am not an unbelieving believer.
I am not an unbeliever.
I am a believing believer.
I am a believing believer.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What's the next verse?
John chapter 11.
Matthew chapter 21, verse number 22. Matthew 21, verse number 22. Kusuta laga libra, kusuta laga lantaya. Lord, we give you glory.
Hallelujah.
Give you praise. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Matthew 21:22. And all things whatsoever ye shall ask in prayer, believing, ye shall receive.
So what's that? Believing.
Believing.
Believing. It's ING. It's a continuous tense. Present continuous tense. It's a believing thing. So no matter what you believe, you want a believing God for one particular thing for one day, and then you stick to it. Tomorrow, you say God cannot do that one. You choose what you believe that God can do. It's a believing. It's a continuity. It's a practical thing that we live. It's not something that we imagine or something that we think. We keep on believing. is this believing actually means keep on believing. You stand with him till the end. You just keep on believing. Somebody, you keep on believing that you're going to make heaven at last.
Amen.
I will keep on believing.
Keep on believing.
That I will make heaven at last. With my family. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It may not look like it right now. It may look as if nothing is working, but there's a believing for me.
Amen.
And it is the Lord Jesus that said so. And as long as I believe what he has said, I'm going to receive at last. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
John 11:40.
Jesus saith unto her, said I not unto thee that if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God?
This is the case of Lazarus where he died and he was buried. And the sisters of Lazarus came and said, no, don't worry, he is already stinking. And the Lord said, after he wept in verse 35. Because the people did not believe. He wept. He said, have I not told that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? Child of God, believing makes us to see the glory of God. Not the glory of this world. Not the glory the world has to offer. If you do not believe in God, you don't believe in his word, you will soon begin to see the glory of this world. You begin to see what the devil is showing you. That's what we studied this morning in our Bible study at home. The Lord God Almighty is calling us to believe him to see his glory. And I'm going to believe him until I see his glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Child of God, the devil is after our foundation. Our foundation is the word of God. That is what we heard. And then we believed. You do not believe what you do not hear. That's what the people heard in the book of Acts chapter 2 after the preaching of Peter when he took the Holy Ghost. They heard it. Look at it in verse 37 of Acts chapter 2. They heard preaching. They did not go there to go and hear all manner of prophecy.
That's right. Now when they heard this, they were pricked in their hearts.
When they heard this, their heart was pricked. They were convicted. Mm-hmm.
And said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles.
And they said to Peter and the rest of the apostles.
Men and brethren. What shall we do?
What shall we do? To be saved. That's what they are asking is for salvation. What shall we do after hearing all these messages? That's when repent came. Child of God, that is the foundation of our faith. We heard the gospel and then we repented. If you have not repented, you will repent today.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The devil doesn't want that. The devil is after it. For that is where we begin to grow our faith. It is called the faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Faith in the word of God. And the Bible says in Psalm 11 verse 3 about this, about foundation. Child of God, God Almighty said it's time for us to go back to our foundation and get it right and be solid in it. Because in Nigeria, a few weeks ago, a 21-story building collapsed. Why? The foundation was not ready for 21-story. The foundation was not ripe for 21-story. The foundation was not mature, was not solidified to carry 21-story. Nigeria would have been in pain by next year. There would have been a great massive bloodshed next year if that building did not collapse this year. Because many people have already bought the house. People have bought complexes. They've paid $1.2 million, $1.5 million. Families have paid. Now they are going to be rejoicing. They don't care the money they lost. Because they can always make money. But they cannot bring back the life. So we celebrate God over Nigeria. Because I don't know, maybe my relation would have been there. Because I have people that have the money that they can pay.
Yes.
God Almighty is calling us to know that foundation is everything. Leave the decoration. Leave the beauty of what we see. There's something underneath that worms can go to. There's something underneath, child of God, that water can go to. And God Almighty said, the devil is after that foundation. Psalm 11 verse 3, what does it say?
If the foundations be destroyed.
If our foundation be destroyed.
What can the righteous do?
That means you're a righteous person. You have the word Jesus in you, but your foundation can be destroyed. Which is the basic gospel that you heard. So before it was only John 3:16 we heard, and then a chorus. We didn't hear big artists. We only heard, only Jesus can save. Hallelujah, only Jesus can save. Hallelujah, only Jesus can save. Hallelujah, only Jesus can save. Hallelujah. Those are the songs that saved us. Not because of any preacher. My girls have not come to our church. We are saved by Jesus Christ. And he still saves. And he will save today.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So we are not going to joke with what the devil is after. We are going to hit on it. We are going to visit it. We are going to go and keep on watering it with that same word we heard.
Amen.
That will keep us to the end.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Child of God, the word of God is a treasure. The Bible, it can be hidden. The Bible must be sought for. We must find it. So look at the book of 2 Corinthians so that you know that the word of God can be hidden. Only treasures are hidden.
Yes.
Oh, I have a wonderful treasure. The gift of God without measure. We will travel together. My Bible and I. Oh, I have a wonderful treasure. The gift of God without measure.
But if our gospel be hid,
uh-huh.
It is hid to them that are lost.
Yes.
In whom the God of this world had blinded the minds of them which believe not.
Uh-huh.
There is the light of the glorious gospel of Christ,
uh-huh.
Who is the image of God, should shine unto them.
Child of God, we're not talking about church members now. It's those that believe. The gospel is hid to those who are lost. There are people that are lost in this world. It's not bright, child of God, we cannot talk about it. There are people who are lost in this world. And God Almighty said, if the gospel is hid, it is hid to them who are lost. Why? They refuse to believe.
Yes.
They believe the words of their preacher. You know, we're in the world now where people are seeing preachers as God. They've replaced God with their preacher. They think that preacher is super daddy. Our super daddy in the Lord, super mommy. I'm not a super mommy in the Lord. I can't say, Chalagaya, I am in Kechi, vulnerable to sin. I can be weak. I eat, child of God. I take bath. If I don't take bath, I'm going to smell. You cannot use my handkerchief. Can you my mouth? It's for me. I can buy a new one for you, but you cannot use mine. Child of God, we are going to wake up to reality.
Yes,
sir. Well, I see there are persons as if this one is bigger than Satan. Who said? Remember, I see the whole world, including your general overseer. He is deceived. Yeah, Kalanta, yeah. God Almighty said the preachers can be taken out. They can need deliverance.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. We will see in the Bible. Preacher can need deliverance.
Hallelujah.
They can need God's intervention.
Yes, sir.
That is why they can have their dead. Child of God, pastors lose their lives. They die.
Yes.
Their family members die.
Yes.
So do not believe them when they tell you that to come and take their handkerchief and their anointing oil. God is calling everybody now to come back to the Bible.
Amen.
What they are believing, come and believe it.
Yes, sir.
Many preachers have become billionaires. Why? You cannot pray. So you want them to be praying for you. And they tell you, before I pray for you, nothing goes for nothing. Nothing goes for nothing. He says, shit, he gets the harvest. Beware of buying prayer. They say, God answers prayer.
Yes,
and it cannot be bought.
Hello.
The Lord is calling you now to be humble. I begin to seek God. Child of God, you have only one life. Recently, some before you read, because these people are lost. Recently, the devil sponsored a young man, a celebrity of the world in America, Travis Scott. Sponsored it to do a very big concert in America. Makosotaya, youth came. Boys and girls, they are dancing. Hey, hey, just like the way they dance in church today, off light, and be raising their hand. It was jam-packed, no seats. Everybody crowded. And he sang a song that says, meet me on the other side. Yeah, Kalantanaga. As he was singing it, there suddenly became a stampede in the place. And people were dying. They didn't stop the concert. They continued. Why? They are carrying people to the other side. Yeah, people are lost. The gospel is not there. And yet there are preachers like T.D. Jakes and Joel Osteen and Kenneth Copeland and all the thieves in America. And they could not stop that thing that is happening there. Makota, they are giving them the vibes to be seeking for pleasure instead of telling them to seek God, the God of salvation. If all the preachers in America are preaching the truth, those youths will not have died. The gospel is hid because they are lost. They are not hearing the word of God. All they are seeing is pictures with their jets. Today they say, I just bought a new jet. I'm the richest billionaire. They are seeing all their beautiful houses in the world they call the islands. They see their children having a man of fun holiday in all the world, in the Caribbean and everywhere, having wonderful time, and they desire it. Child of God, the world knows that people with gospel, they have no time for pleasure. The world knows. So when they see people of God, preachers, having pleasure in this world, they do not believe gospel anymore. They know how Jesus ought to be. God Almighty said it is time for us to know that there are people that are lost in this world. Oh, souls are crying. Men are dying. Would you leave them to the not get them back. When I heard the news, when I heard the story, my heart was bleeding because it could have been my child there. Do you know where your child is right now? Do you know what they're doing right now? Some of our children may even have been watching it online. They have been connected. We don't know. Because these people are being sponsored by the devil to capture the hearts of the youth. But our God will pull them out.
Amen.
Our daddy God will pull down our youths.
Amen.
From the hands of the devil.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
They do not need all those concerts. They need gospel. They need the word of God. Child of God, I know there are concerts that look spiritual. They go there and shout, outpouring. They go and do the artificial fire. Child of God, it does not save soul. People can come up for altar call, but doesn't save soul. We don't know what happened under the altar call. For many people have euphoria. Emotionalism is in the church. It's in music, because music has vibration. Music has frequency. Music can carry you to a level where you think you are with God. Like a labor, because that the devil did it. He can't put it in the top of the holy temple. And that was, yet he's going there to tempt them with his glory. He has done it to many preachers. He has done it to many gospel singers. Many are lost even inside the church. Why? They have rejected the gospel. But God Almighty is calling us. Did you read? In whom the God of this world has
blinded the minds of them which believe not.
Child of God, it is a mind blinding. I was covering my eye, and the Lord said, the eye can be open, but the mind is blind.
Yes.
And that is why it takes God to come and enlighten us and open the eyes of our understanding to see the invisible realm. Child of God, happy are ye when you can see the invisible realm. But you see what God is seeing. Nothing will move in this world, though. Yeah, can I tell you? Child of God, you will never be caught in the web of the devil. There is a God of this world with a small g.
Yes.
Be not deceived. I say all the good things in this world belong to God. Child of God, God Almighty has no time. He came for your soul and my soul.
Yes,
we are the treasure here. My God's so there. Once he has come to pick his children, that's when you know that nothing is in this world. He will melt it down.
Oh.
You have no time for these things. It is the devil that magnifies it. God, somebody quoted the scripture. Holy Ghost, thank you. About God has pleasure in the prosperity of his saints. Please look for it. I don't know if it's in the book of Psalm that God takes pleasure. Check 35. Lord, Holy Ghost, help me. This scripture, it dropped in my spirit. He that has pleasure in the prosperity of his saints. They quote it a lot. Check Psalm 35. Makosu Tanaka. If the Lord there, search for it. Before we finish this podcast, we need to read that scripture. That take a pleasure in the prosperity of his servants. Is it there? Have you seen it? Is it Psalm 35?
Yes.
Holy Ghost really wants us to read it. Psalm 35, verse 27.
Let them shout Thank for you. Joy.
Let them shout for joy.
And be glad.
And be glad.
That favor my righteous cause.
Look at what God is saying. All of them are quoting this verse. You jump to say God has pleasure. He said that favor my righteous cause. People who are following my way. People who are sponsoring gospel. That is God's righteous cause. Those who want souls to be saved. Like those youths in America, they shouldn't go to hell. Those of you that are into my righteous cause, they should shout for joy and be glad.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Let them say continually.
Let them say continually.
Let the Lord be magnified.
Let the Lord be magnified.
Which had pleasure in the prosperity of
Are you seeing where the Lord brought prosperity? He has finished putting himself ahead, putting his kingdom ahead. Nobody can catch God, though.
Yes.
You can't catch him because of that. Preachers go to the last line. I said, let God. God has prosperity in the prosperity of his. Is it who did he call them? Is it servants?
Servants.
But some preachers said that God can never call them servants, that they are sons. God Almighty said it is his servant that he knows that he's going to serve him. He's going to follow his righteous cause. He's going to make sure souls are one that is going to give him all the glory. He's going to magnify the Lord. Oh, the Lord be magnified.
The Lord be magnified.
The Lord be magnified.
The Lord be magnified.
The Lord be magnified. The Lord be magnified. Be magnified. As the part of the altar, let's all just sing and rejoice and be glad. Sing you, rejoice and be glad in you. Let all the sing you, rejoice and be glad in you. In you. As such as love your salvation, your salvation. Sing continually. Oh, let such as love your salvation. To want to gain things, but he has put his condition there. They favor his righteous cause, that they are for salvation, and that they have magnified the Lord. Nobody knows them. They are just servants. So such people will be prosperous in doing his work. We are in that category. Are you a servant?
I am a servant.
Do you support God's righteous cause?
Yes.
Will you magnify the Lord?
Yes.
The Lord is going to honor our prayer.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Child of God, God Almighty said, the word of God is his sure banker for his children in the last days.
Amen.
What is rebellion? Rebellion is when you decide to open Bible and obey it. They say are rebellious. Why? People don't read Bible. That's the last rebellion of the last days. The rebellion of the last days is that when you read Bible and decide to obey it, you are a rebel. That is our name. We continue rebel. Why? I read Bible. And I want to follow what I read. So I cannot be inside the cocoon of a religious sect. Of course, so today I cannot follow an organization. Why? They follow what their pastor says. They follow what their general overseer says. They listen to the prophecy of the year and follow it. Yeah, Kalante. I follow the prophecy that is called the small songbird of prophecy. This is what I follow. Child of God, are you a rebel?
Yes.
If you're not a rebel with Bible, you are not yet qualified for heaven. Anybody that will make heaven, you must be called a rebel. Why? Because you are following what the Bible says. You refuse to budge. You refuse to bow. You are distinct. You are separate. You are different. God Almighty is looking for such children.
Amen.
He has found in Ketio. This small girl here. He has found me. And that is why you can see that God Almighty helps us on global altar. giving us scripture. And he will tell us where it is. I don't know. I'm excited in my spirit that God Almighty can come to our new estate. To him be all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God Almighty said in his testimony that there are seducing spirits in the last days, because the devil cannot be after foundation of faith for nothing. He's going to come in seduction. Go to the book of 1 Timothy chapter number 4, 1 to 13. 1 Timothy chapter number 4, 1 to 13. Child of God, the word of God is what we need in the last days. That's why the Holy Spirit came. If you go to the book of John 14, 26, John 15, 26, these are scriptures of global altar. John 16, 13, the essence of the Holy Spirit is because of God's word. Doesn't want us to understand it with our brain. Doesn't want us to go to Bible college for it. Child of God, Bible college is useless. Bible college will not help you to walk away from sin. Child of God, Bible college has no power. It will only teach you head knowledge. It will teach you logos. It will teach you all the things that make you more confused. The Holy Ghost is our teacher. Before you go to that first Timothy, because it's a Bible study, you can see it's 13 verses. Why don't you read these verses? Read the three of them. So that everybody that doesn't have the Holy Spirit begin to cry and desire the Holy Ghost. John 14, 26. Open that one. Then I will tell you the next one, just the next chapter 26.
John chapter 14, verse 26.
Yes, sir.
But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost.
The Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost.
Whom the Father will send in my name.
Whom the Father will send in my name. Are you seeing how God is being putting Father, Son, Holy Spirit together? That make people call it Trinity.
But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost,
is God's Spirit,
whom the Father will send in my name.
Whom Daddy, who has the Spirit, will send in the name of Jesus Christ that we know.
He shall teach you all things.
He shall teach you all things.
And bring all things to your remembrance.
He will bring all things to our remembrance.
Whatever I have said unto you.
Whatever he has said to us. So if that means if you don't read the Bible, you cannot have help. Without reading the Bible, nothing to remind. I don't care how you speak in tongues. If you are going for an exam, you don't read for that exam, nothing will be helped. Holy Spirit helps what has been put in you. He now brings it to light. That's how it works. Yes, son?
15:26.
Yes, sir.
But when the Comforter is come.
Are you seeing a backup when the Comforter is come?
Whom I will send unto you from the Father.
Whom I will send to you from the Father. Are you seeing that he's calling now? Before he said the Father will send, see that there one.
Whom I will send unto you.
I will send the Father, I said the Father will send in my name. Are you seeing that God Almighty is telling us to come and know that he is one?
Yes.
There's no confusion here. Holy Ghost, I thank you. I didn't even know before.
Yes,
it's my first time of seeing this.
Whom
I will send.
Whom I will send unto you from the Father.
From the Father.
Even the Spirit of truth.
Is the Spirit of truth.
Which proceeded from the Father.
That means the Spirit of lie is from the devil. That one is in John 8:44. That is the Spirit of the lie of the devil. This is the Spirit of truth.
He shall testify of me.
He shall testify of Jesus Christ. Stop giving testimony of church. You are against God. You are an antichrist. Stop looking for antichrist, but many of us, you have antichrist right there in your home. Yes, antichrist from the pulpits. Yeah, can I? Why? They're testifying of what they can do,
that's right,
of their prayer. Testimonies will be about Jesus Christ.
Yes,
to testify of him. What does it say in 16:13?
John chapter 16, verse 13.
How
be it when he.
I'll be ready.
The Spirit of truth is come.
The Spirit of truth, that means that he's talking about one God. It is a he, Makoso Tanagayatia. It is he that is the Spirit of truth. Because if he's not a one, that means Jesus is the Spirit of lie. Father is the Spirit of lie. Child of God is talking about him.
That's right.
When it's he, one God. When he, the Spirit of truth, shall come.
He's come.
It's come.
He will guide you into all truth.
He will guide you into all truth.
For he shall not speak of himself.
He will not speak of himself.
But whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak.
He is going to speak what he shall hear, and what he hears is what you are studying in his word.
Hallelujah.
Child of God, God Almighty is going to know that he knows how to practice his word.
Yes, sir.
So we must practice it.
Yeah.
How? There was once a man called the Ethiopian eunuch who was in his chariot reading the scripture in Isaiah. He didn't know what he was speaking. And God Almighty said, I can hear you speaking. So Holy Spirit, pass into Philip and go teach him. Go soon to Nicolantia. Teach him the word. That's why I know the Holy Ghost, because he came in with transport, but we don't know how he left. The Philip airline, we don't know what happened. How he left that chariot. Child of God, suddenly was not there. Why? Holy Ghost was in charge of that teaching. The Lord God Almighty is calling us to know that the Holy Spirit is what He gave to who? He gave to us. Thank you, Lord. He gave us the Holy Spirit to interpret the Word of God. So you don't need versions. The Holy Spirit can interpret this King James Version for you.
Yes.
Because we are enjoying King James. I can't read another version. If I read another version, it looks like a magazine for me. This is the Word of God. This is the original.
Hallelujah.
This is the native book.
Yes.
This is the old one.
Thank you, Lord.
We don't want any new book. We want this one. And God is helping us with it.
Amen.
He will help you elsewhere.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let's go to our Bible study.
Hallelujah.
1 Timothy.
Chapter 4.
Yes.
1 to 13.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
1 Timothy chapter 4, I read from verse 1.
Yes, sir.
Now the Spirit speaketh expressly.
That same Holy Spirit is now speaking.
Mm-hmm. That in the latter times.
As we are there, we are in the latter times.
Some shall depart from the faith.
Child of God, this is a prophetic word that was said about 2,000 years ago.
Yes, sir.
And now it's coming to pass in our time.
Yes.
Child of God, don't think that these words are fallen. Don't say it's not for our time. It's whose time? It's for our Bible. It is manifesting already.
Yes.
Read on.
We are in the latter times.
We're in the latter times. Yes.
Some shall depart from the faith.
The Lord said there are people that are, we know, preachers, strong Christians, but some of them will depart from the faith.
Giving heed to seducing spirits.
Because their foundation has been touched. They'll be giving heed to seducing spirits
and doctrines of devils.
And doctrines of devils.
Speaking lies in hypocrisy.
They'll be beware of prophecy. They'll be speaking lies. You see all these eight that they speak lies in hypocrisy. They will bring more truth. Mm-hmm. Then they will package it with some lies.
Yes.
So you are confused because mm-hmm. you have received one truth that you felt liberated in your soul.
Yes,
but then they bring the lie, you will not know. Marcus, speaking lies in hypocrisy.
Having their conscience seared with a hot iron.
And they are going to stick to it. They are going to say, this is what God told me. God told me. Whenever I hear all these fake apostles saying, God told me in my bedroom, God told me. I say, oh, Father, have mercy. This people's hearts is being seared with hot iron. They are not open. They do not remember that there was once an old prophet in 1 Kings 13 who had from the devil. He said, an angel told me, and the devil is also an angel. That he can hear from the devil and kill a young man. And yet he will see her again from God. Because he did later on. Child of God, people are people who think that they are always hearing from God.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Forbidding to marry and commanding to abstain from it.
Beware of Catholic Church. Beware of Catholic Church who say do not marry. They put priests in bondage. And now most of the priests now, they are into homosexual. They are into gay. They are now ritual killers. Why? They have to donate their sperm to their, what they call that, their Catholic trainer. They say what for that? They are in their monastery. They have, yes, they are things that they do in that. There's a Vatican. There's a cabal there. So they have to donate sperm. They have the nuns that they have to impregnate to bring out babies for them to do their blood sacrifice, their ritual. That thing that they drink, that they call communion, is bloody. There's blood in it. Every communion of Catholic Church has blood. Go and write it down. This is what God Almighty is telling you in Catholic Church. All the communion there is not pure wine. There's a trace of blood. Why? It has to covenant your soul permanently to Catholic Church. If you want to fight with a Catholic, go and tell them that they are in the wrong place. Go and quarrel with them. Speak against their Pope. They are going to tear you. They will set you up. They will jail you. Why? They have drunk blood. So they are covenanted permanently to the Vatican. Lord God, have mercy.
Yes, Lord.
People are ready to donate their children to the Catholic sect. They need to give them. What did they do in confirmation? What did you mean of confirmation of their children? It's a covenant. It's a take care. It's a, oh, God have mercy. God is going to bring out these children.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God almighty say, beware of shutting like Christ embassy. Because they don't value marriage. Here, Calatia. They can say the man can live in this corner of the world. The wife lives there. That is that not that God is not in all this marriage thing. God is after ministry and so. These are Satan's children. Beware of those churches. Beware of churches who do not value marriage. God Almighty said they are of the devil who agree to divorce. Any church you see that agree to divorce and remarry, like all these winners, they are not of God.
Any church that does not care that somebody has dumped his wife and is busy doing as if he has everything because he has money, they are condoning with the person. They are calling the person a child of God. God said, that pastor is not of him. He, God, can never ever support divorce. We will see more of it if Jesus studies on Friday, because he made a question on Friday. God Almighty said, when you begin to see people fighting marriage that God Almighty took time to do, is joining in Genesis, they are not of him. It is called seducing spirits. For many have been seduced out of their marriage. There is one on this group on Facebook. There's a preacher on Facebook, I'm almost tempted to call his name, who has been seduced to push his wife and his three children away to take in a young girl. Yeah, can look at that. He needed to seduce his spirits. They seduced him out of the marriage. They said, this is not the will of God. You didn't pay your dowry to the right parents. But you paid the dowry, because how you paid the dowry, and to pay poor, come out there. And then the original parents of the girl, who is not her fault, she didn't present to you wrong parents, she did not know. Yeah, can look at that. It's not her fault. Hey, yeah. There was no love. There was no love. He had been seduced by somebody you call a prophetess. Who, beware of preachers who are prophetess. They will never want their wives anymore. Because men want spiritual women. I know what I'm talking about. I've had a situation with a pastor who told me he wishes I am his wife. Why? Because I have a gift. Yeah. Every minister, every preacher wants spiritual wife. Hey, prophetess, I've been prophesying, I've been leading prayer. Why? More money. More crowd. It attracts people. You know, all these Oluburi them in Nigeria, them, their wife is prophet, they are pastor. They are always to be checking how much they are bringing. Why their wives are prophesying. We know what is happening. Beware of preachers and churches who look down on marriage. They are seducers. They are not after the joy of the people. They are after what they will get from them. And God is going to deliver his children.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Read our psalm.
Forbidding to marry and commanding to abstain from meats, which God had created to be received with thanksgiving.
Child of God, beware of olive oil and revelation all over the place. Don't eat that. They are seducers. Why? They want to draw members to themselves. They want to draw souls to themselves that will make them to become the head of their hearts. Yeah. That whenever they dream anything, they will run to them to interpretation. Who cannot have mercy. Beware of people who always have points to give that God said about something. The heart for that revelation about scarf, that revelation about it. Tell God, our revelation is God's word.
Yes.
Is it in the Bible? Whatever is not here is not necessary. Yes. That means God doesn't sound important for eternity. The word of God has all the answers.
Yes,
I don't need to have somebody come and tell me I've got to pray about revelation about something. No, the word of God can give it to us. We can pray about it. And God will open our eyes to the scripture. Do you know that I have known that Psalm 35 before? For years, I didn't know it where I know it now. God has opened my eyes to understand that that prosperity is not to be carrying dollar and be buying car and be doing things. It is a prosperity for him, for his glory, for him to be magnified. That is why any preacher you see that is emphasizing on prayer of God, Father, make me great, is a fake preacher, is a seducer. Spirit of Father, make me great. He's not of God. Why? He is the great God. Our God.
Yes,
he's a great God.
Yes,
a great God.
Oh,
above. Oh, our God.
Yes, sir.
There's no greatest.
No.
He's great. God Almighty is calling us that he is the great God.
Yes,
so he's calling us to stay to know that there are seducers who can seduce us out of making him our number one. We are to make him the number one in the whole world. I am not number one. No preacher is number one.
No.
He has made himself number one.
Yes.
He says, seek ye first. He put himself as first. He called himself the first and the last.
Yes,
child of God, God Almighty, call us to be humble.
Yes, Lord.
And not follow these preachers who make us proud and covetous. I heard it recently in a very big program. A preacher was telling the members, pray, Father, among everybody, bless me first. These are wicked prayers that God cannot answer. What do you mean, bless me first? God is saying that you have something to repent of. You're a liar. You're a fornicator. Child of God, people have said to me, from June 1 to November, how many souls have you won? Who did you preach to? That God has nobody settling. He has settled all.
Yes,
he said it is finished.
Yes,
so that prayer of settle me, child of God, the settlement is about heaven. Where he settled his word. So forever, O Lord, thy word is settled in heaven. Our settlement is not here. We cannot settle here. Our settlement is in heaven, child of God. Beware of that 1 Peter 5:10 that quoting. And I've suffered a while, a lot of that. I'm child of God is heaven settlement. Not here. There's a God that knows his word. We cannot twist him. No preacher can twist God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Read up, child.
Which God hath created to be received with thanksgiving of them which believe
and
know the truth.
Somebody say believe.
Believe.
Believers that know the truth, these things don't move us. That's why we must know God. We must know what he's saying about every situation.
Mm-hmm.
Every situation has Bible verse, child of God. God Almighty said, when we know his word and believe, we will not be moved. Read on.
For every creature of God is good.
Aha.
And nothing to be refused.
Hallelujah.
Amen. If it be received with thanksgiving.
Somebody say thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving.
Are you the power of thanksgiving?
Yes, sir.
Child of God, there's no way that we are in a time where we're not going to go through this. The time is coming. It may not be now, because now we have our bread, we have everything. The time is coming when something will be presented.
Yes.
So, we will not always have salad.
Yes, sir.
A time is coming when it may be just ordinary leaves.
Yes,
we pluck on the road.
Hey,
and God will anoint it.
Yes.
And we'll give him thanks. And we eat to eat.
Yes.
So God, beware of binding when you're eating. You see, this binding we bind. Father, anybody that touches this food before it is that bind it. You do not believe in God. Did Jesus buy the bread and fish?
No.
Did he buy the bread and fish?
No.
Thanksgiving. Maybe the mother of the bread is a witch. Who knows? But he did not buy it. Why? He received it in
thanksgiving.
He raised it to God and said, Daddy, eat first.
Hey.
At the end of the day, the thing went round.
Hey.
I had extra. Child of God, God Almighty is calling out to follow his way. So we don't get lost in this world. I'm going to say, how am I going to survive? How will I get a job? They sack me because of I didn't take the pay rent pay. How am I going to survive? Child of God, beware of looking for help for yourself. We are to look to the hills. From whence cometh our help? Our help comes from the Lord, which made the heavens and the earth. There is a God that can open the eyes of Hagar to see water in the desert. And God says, go and drink. Take care of this land, and the land shall be great. God Almighty said he can present a lack so that he can speak his word. If not for the lack of water, will God bless Ishmael?
No.
If Ishmael had all the water, will God come and speak?
No.
God Almighty came and spoke because there was no water. And when he provided water, he said, not only water, I'm going to make him great. Child of God, give thanks to God. Lift your voice, give thanks to God. Whatever you have, give thanks to God. Lift your voice, say, thank you, Lord Jesus. In everything in my life, I'm going to give you thanks, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
What
does he say? Verse number?
Verse 5. But it is sanctified by the word of God.
We don't practice it now. It is sanctified by the word of God and prayer. Child of God, God is above all.
Yes.
Don't be afraid of human being. Human being cannot poison you.
At all.
You shall eat deadly things, it shall not hurt you. Unless God opens your eyes and says, do not eat. If he has not cautioned you, child of God, God must receive with thanksgiving. The word of God and prayer sanctifies it.
Yes,
I know what I'm talking about. I've gone through a lot of things. Whenever we are going to do work inside places where they don't really have what we normally are used to, we follow it up with faith, with prayer, and God has taken care of us.
Right.
And he will take care of us.
Amen.
In the times we are entering,
yes.
When it looks very hard, he's going to take care of us.
Amen.
Take care of the children.
Amen.
Because about few, didn't realize you know how to teach. He's turning you to become the headmistress of your children.
Amen.
He's making you principal.
Amen.
You don't want to open school, Zion. You don't want to open school. Go to my say you are going to be principal. In your small room there,
Amen.
He's going to bring children around.
Amen.
He will teach them the word of God.
Amen.
If I tell you children, a little ABC and 1, 2, 3, and the OBC, boy, God Almighty said they write any exam, they come out excellent.
Hallelujah.
This one is for somebody over there.
Thank you, Lord.
So don't cry for school fees. Yeah, Kalanta, I've got a pot to give you a school.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God.
Amen.
Say verse 6, if thou
put the brother in remembrance of these things.
Are you seeing what God is looking for preachers?
Mm-hmm.
All online ministers, this is the will of God for you, verse 6.
If thou put the brother in remembrance of these things.
Put brethren in remembrance of these things. Tell them that these are going to happen. Stop promising them blessing.
That shall be a good minister.
The Lord said, this is a good minister.
Nourish up in the words of faith.
He is a good minister of who? Jesus Christ. God has no time for these churches. The Lord said, if you remind people that there will be seducing spirits in the last days that are going to want to spoil their marriages, but telling that if your husband are taking paper and pay, wife, don't sleep with him. Hey, cannot. These are seducing spirits to destroy homes. I thank God for delivering those families. God Almighty said, you are a good minister. I am a good minister.
I am a good minister of Jesus Christ.
The glory of Jesus Christ. God Almighty said, we are to nourish people up. In the words of faith
and of good doctrine.
And of good doctrine. That is a bad doctrine.
Yes.
Doctrine of bless me first. Doctrine of I want to be great. They are bad doctrines.
Doctrine
of devils. God is not there. I cannot focus on that. Doctrine that we want to be like the most high. People of competitions, most beautiful this, most that, best this, best that. They are doctrine of devil. No, I don't want to best anything. God has been teaching me about things. God keeps teaching me. God have mercy on me. He gives me information. He sees all these best things. I want to be the best in and out of me. There are doctrines of the devil. That's seducing doctrines. They make you not to think of me. You think of self. And you have to die to self every day. So you cannot improve self. The Bible says, believe in God. Not believe in me.
Yes, sir.
Believe in God. Believe also in me. Not believe in self. You cannot believe in yourself. You believe in God. We are not to have anything to do with self. It's all about God.
Yes,
God Almighty said, it is time for us to begin to know who has good doctrine and follow them.
Mm-hmm.
We are unto
thou hast a thing. But refuse profane and old wives.
Refuse profane.
And old wives fables.
Old wives fables. God Almighty is going out. I saw people are doing concert in Lagos. They call it outpouring. And I saw the young man. I pity that young man. God is going to restore to Brother Dulce. He was saying, I see person that goes on the throne worshiping God. I see my late wife worshiping God. I say, Father, preserve your son. They want to corrupt him. They want to spoil him. He was calling dead people. I say, I am Baba Lala worshiping on the throne. But see, he was authenticating them that they are in heaven. He was bearing false witness because that's only where they are. Child of God, it is dangerous to begin to call people's names when you are worshiping God. You cannot mingle the dead and the living. If you must call anybody, there are 24 elders. They are alive till date. You're going to see them when we get there. You can see they are worshiping God. Yes, God Almighty said, you are to worship the Father. Leave people alone. Leave God as a person alone and worship the Father in spirit and in truth. God Almighty said, it is time for us to come out of these old principles. Come out of all these things that are called profane babblings and exercise thyself
rather unto godliness.
Whenever you see this word rather, God has condemned something.
Yes.
Don't do this, rather do this. That same thing is what is there in the book of 1 Peter 3 about jewelry and all those dressing. God Almighty is calling you and I to know that it's time to pursue godliness, which can only be found in the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The word of God is God's textbook. It's the book to know God. You want to know God? Go to God's handout. Go to God's tutorial. Go to God's textbook. And you will be godly.
Amen.
You cannot be eating the food of the world and you want to be godly. You have to eat the food of God to be godly. You eat the food of the world to be worldly.
Yes.
Hey, that's how it goes. But cause to tell you there. Child of God, you eat African food to be African. You eat Chinese food to be China. Once you go to China, Chinese restaurant, you have left the country.
My Lord.
You can be in Nigeria and you are in China. How? All the waiters, they are in Chinchon, China. Their plate is China, their chopsticks is China, the food is China, the music is China. So you can leave Nigeria into China in a Chinese restaurant. China, God, right now, global altar, we are in God's table, which He prepared before us, He prepared for our enemies. They cannot hinder God's word. China, God, nobody can touch God's word. And we are going to stick with it. Verse 8.
For bodily exercise profiteth little,
uh-huh,
but godliness is profitable unto all things.
Beware of fitness center. Beware of exercise and gym. For many of us, you want to kill the fat of the flesh, but you have the fat of the spirit.
Mm.
Inside your spirit, you are loaded with anger, lust, bitterness. It's saturated. You have not cut it off. But we should lay them aside. They are called weeds.
Yes,
why? These things will not allow us to run our heavenly race. We must run light. When God Almighty talks to us, He wants us to use natural things to know. Tell God, nobody wears suits to go and run. My cousin there. Does anybody wear skirt suits?
No.
Anybody wear three-piece suits?
No.
Anybody wear bowler hats?
No.
Yeah, Kalosa, Talagaya. Child of God, the light down, the boy, the best to run. Ah, Talagaya. When you are light, spiritually, you are light of sin and cares of this world. We are having many devotion a few days ago, and I was surprised. I heard a whistle at the back. I thought it was my son that was whistling, David. So I thought, David is not the one whistling. Who was whistling? My daughter. I said, praise God, whistle. Because I'm 52. I can't whistle. It's off. I cannot whistle. I have tried. Every time when I hear whistle, I want to whistle like that. I said, for it cannot come out. Child of God, I don't know. There's no school for whistle. We are going to learn how to whistle. But if I take kids in that whistle, kids, can you whistle? Are you hearing whistle? No, who is better? Child of God, is that he's better than me whistling? God Almighty is calling that there's something better.
Yes.
Godliness is better.
It's profitable unto all things.
God is calling us to come out of this issue of wanting to look good, to please people, to impress people. Faith, godliness, fat people are entry level. Sleep people are going to hell. We have to say it too. Sleep souls, son, they're going to hell. Fat people have mansion that size there. Hallelujah. Don't go and die and be starving. Child of God, don't be starving to be slain. Why? Your lineage is full of fat people. Child of God, God is calling us to come out of these things of the world.
Yes.
It's what you believe that is going to work on you.
Yes.
I don't believe in those things. I eat what I want to eat. Yes, and I receive a thanksgiving. Child of God, and I eat. Yes, I ate here. I see her yesterday, child of God. I don't care. God Almighty said there are things that He has given to us in this world for us to enjoy them. All this food that you are throwing away because you are going to have cancer. Who said? There are people who do not eat this thing. They are in us.
Yes.
I know people who don't eat anything, but they are sick, having cancer.
Yes.
These are spiritual diseases.
Mm-hmm.
If sickness were not spiritual, why did Jesus die for it?
Mm-hmm.
And received came for it.
Yes.
It's a spiritual matter. Of course, so tell them. Stop pursuing sickness with physical.
Mm-hmm.
If they are doing anything about health, pray over all those tests.
Mm-hmm.
The devil has a way of changing color of things. Your hearing can go to them yellow. When they are seeing it, they are seeing it black thing. I pray over this.
Yes.
Over this blood. When they take blood, we pray.
Yes.
We full of it with prayer.
Yes.
Why? There is a God of this world.
Yes.
Who can give you one information that can scatter your life?
Yes.
One wrong information can send you packing. You die before the real result comes out. God is going on. It is time for us to focus on Him.
Yes.
Stop pursuing the things of this world. Leave your eyebrow. You don't need to do anything. Leave the eyelash. Leave the things God gave you on the body. Leave your skin. You are pursuing things that are going to lead you to hell.
Mm.
Why? They're living with pride.
Oh, sure.
Godliness is
profitable
unto all things. I shall be godly.
I shall be godly.
I shall pursue the word of God.
I shall pursue the word of God.
To get my full godliness in God.
Godliness
in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Verse 9 says what?
But godliness is having promise of the life that now is and of that which is to come.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We will finish well.
Amen.
Amen.
God is telling us that as many of us are pursuing godliness, we are going to finish well.
Amen.
We conclude our race.
Amen.
And then we are going to enter the life after.
Amen.
Which is eternity.
Hallelujah.
With God.
Amen.
Child of God, it's not a battle of one life, one man die, go. No, we don't go to die, go. We are going somewhere. There is still 20 days, there is life which is to come. Who said die go? My die go. What he consign me? He go consign you. Yeah, can I tell the guy go consign you? Your eye go open.
Yes,
I go tell the guy. He go say, ah, what he happen? It don't happen, no. We don't enter. We not go fit come back.
Yes,
yeah, can I go consign them? For the one that we preaching. We have to preach and preach. For people to come and receive the deep way of God.
My Lord.
In our mother tongue.
Hallelujah.
Read the old verse 9. This is
a faithful saying.
Uh-huh.
And worthy of all acceptation.
All of us accept it too.
Yes.
Tell of God, any person that doesn't accept this word is not of God. All acceptation. Say, I accept this word.
I accept this word.
For my profit.
For my profit.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Understand?
For therefore, we both labor and suffer reproach.
Uh-huh.
Because we trust in the living God.
Uh-huh.
Who is the Savior of all men.
Uh-huh.
Especially of those that believe.
I am a believer.
Yeah.
Oh, possibility we are talking about here is that I can go through suffering and I'm not denying him.
Yes, I will not deny him.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Can you go through reproach and you not deny the Lord?
Yes,
sir.
I will not deny him.
God Almighty said that this is what we will go through. We will both labor and suffer
reproach. Because we trust in the living God.
Because we refuse to take people in pain.
Ripping.
Are you saying the Bible is correct?
Mm-hmm.
Because we say we're not going to submit for job, we're going to suffer for it.
Because
I am your Savior.
Amen.
Oh, you are the Savior of my soul, my Jesus, my Jesus. Oh, you are the Savior. He is the Savior of all men. That means the believing is for everybody. Anyone who believes, whosoever, it is not in the custody of being a member of any particular church. It is in the custody of being with one particular preacher. God Almighty says it is when we trust in the living God.
Who is the Savior of all men?
Especially
of those that believe.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell them God don't throw away the foundation of your faith in God is our believing.
Hallelujah.
God has not changed because we're going through things. Child of God, what we are going through is part and parcel of God to remind us that He is with us. That's why you're not dying in it. My cousin, sometimes you think you're going to be suffocated. You're not suffocated.
Mm-hmm.
You came out of it.
Hallelujah.
There's somebody that believes God that God abandons. God Almighty doesn't allow to be ashamed.
Oh
Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. My Redeemer, Lord, I believe. Oh, you never allow me to be ashamed. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. My Redeemer, Lord, I believe. Lift your voice as the to be ashamed. Oh, Lord, I believe. Lord, I excited. I'm so excited in God. Why? This is a word of assurance and reassurance. And as long as I am still believing in this Bible, I will never be put to shame. He's going to save me. He will save my children. He will save my family. He will save you as well. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says these things.
Command and teach.
Somebody say command.
Command.
Child of God, command is not like wearing uniform. There are some churches that they wear uniform. My cousin, I say they are general. Command is the people that are his commander. Cousin, they are those that are telling people that they are going to suffer. Now that God is going to bless them. When else did you hear it told that you will suffer? You can't hear it now. But God said these things do what? Command
and teach.
Quem, full stop, QED. Unchallengeable, say, Fini, it's finished. God Almighty said, there's a full stop. These things command and teach.
Let no man despise thy youth.
Nobody has power to talk. If they try it, I'm going to show them that I'm the one that sent you a message. If you have 10 hands, touch the bar altar. You can see fire. Why? We are obeying God. These things command and teach. Let no man despise thy widowhood. But be thou an example
of the believers.
Of Christians.
Yes, sir. In word.
Is it Christians?
Believers.
Bible reader. Please read what is here.
Believers.
God Almighty said his believer. Yes, be thou example to all the believers.
In word.
In the word of God.
In conversation.
In the way you live your lifestyle.
In charity.
In the way you show love.
In spirit.
In your spiritual life.
In faith.
In your faith.
In purity.
In your holiness. In your purity. Child of God, how can believers know pure people when you are wearing trousers, sister? There's a physical show for believers. Let me say, sister, that men will see. Men are to see. God say men look at out of the appearance. He didn't condemn it. He said, I gave my eye to see. He asked a blind man, what is he said? I see men as things. Then he said, God, I want to see things. You can't blind me and say, face the spirit. I can't see spirit. I'm seeing your body. I'm seeing you opening your breast. You are blocking me. I can't see God. Sister, I'm seeing your eye shadow. I'm seeing your things. We cannot flow. God Almighty said, you should drop them. For purity. Purity means there's no addendum. There's no addition. That means not purity. Raw. That's why you go and buy Goya oil, but that's fourth grade. That olive oil you're buying is the fourth grade. It's not the pure one. They have done things. They have added additives and all preservation. Child of God, God Almighty talking about purity. Can be seen crystal clear, can be seen like there's no particle inside. Child of God, I don't care how you have faith. If you want to drink a glass of water, even if it came from me, that you know I will not poison you, and you see a drop, a little tiny drop of dirt, you are not going to drink it. Why? You don't know what is there. It can be poo, it can be an ant. It can be African witch. Holy Ghost, have mercy on me. Because anytime my children are coming from abroad, I have to clean everywhere. They must not see soot. Have mercy. We have to be clean and see everything. We are pure here. We don't have any African voodoo. Because the children are going to see this. The children see this. What's that, Grandma? What's that? Lord, have mercy on me. God Almighty says it's not for us to go into purity. Say purity.
Purity.
That is what we have to show. Example.
Yes, sir.
Cleanliness. People must see each other. God says, God sees my heart. I don't care what is there. I'm not in your heart. I don't want to know. All I want to know is what you're doing physically. For when I see it physically, I will know what is in your heart.
Yes, sir.
Kings.
Till I come. Give attendance to reading.
Apostle Paul, Brother Paul said he has a time that he will come for physical teaching. So we are trusting God that one day we are going to have live audience.
Amen.
But some of you, I want to come live.
Amen.
And see what God Almighty is also doing.
Amen.
The Lord God Almighty said there's a time for us to speak like this. There's a time for us to have physical contact, like our Zoom prayer. Some of you don't want prayer, so you cannot come from our Zoom prayer. It's 2.5 hours. And it is Tuesdays and Thursdays. So if you want to join Zoom prayer to boost your prayer life, to boost your intimacy with God, come and inbox us. and God Almighty will help us because we have given this past what they call the code to people, to dozens, but we don't see them, of course. So we can still give you the code to fulfill our righteousness so that you can come and join us in prayer.
Amen.
Because we are sometimes we have 10 disciples, 9 disciples, 12 disciples, but we are pressing on.
Hallelujah.
And God is preserving us. He said, till I come,
give attendance to reading.
Give attendance to prophecy.
Reading.
Tell me, what don't you read? There is a word I put when I'm sending soul into the glory of God, I put wise counsel. If you truly want to feed your precious soul to know and connect with God, read all the scriptures. People don't read. They don't read it. They only manage to read the memory verse and the Bible text. And that's the end. I say, we have tried. Can't you leave us? Lord, have mercy on me. Meanwhile, we took time to do Bible study, to bring up verses, to back up the word. But you don't have time. But you have time to read, send your account details. Lord, have mercy on this word. You know how to interpret, send your bank account. You do not waste time. Some people will just send it. You say, ah, what's it? What happened? You have been saving it. Yeah, Kalantaya. Child of God, beware. Beware of when you magnify mammon. Hey, Kalantaya. Today, so me. You know, I sent some of the glory of the world.
Yes.
I sent many things.
Yes.
And I was telling my children, some people will say, God, give me some of this thing. No, Sukala. If only I can have small of this, I'll be okay. I don't want plenty. Oh, Lord, how much? It was a test. God told me, put it. Let's see, don't I go to desire this thing. Ah, Kalantaya. Lord, how much you are mean? How much you are mean, Lord? In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God Almighty is going to come out of glory of this world. Poverty will not touch our soul. And we're not poor, child of God. We are rich in Christ. He knows how much we can bear. He's going to meet our needs. In the name of Jesus Christ. There was one that is sandwiched and they put on his hand. If I can only have this sandwich. Hey, Lord, how much? Lord, oh, you are enough for me. You are enough for me. The man of Calvary, you are enough for me. Oh, you are enough for me. Is it enough for you? What is in our hearts, and he's helping us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Give attendance to reading,
to exhortation,
to exhortation,
to doctrine.
Bonquem, bonquem, R-U-E-D, read. You say you will not forget to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. So write read, give attention to read, and that read is the blood of Jesus Christ. And that red is the scarlet thread that Rahab puts that saved her and her family. Child of God, God Almighty said, this is his will. Keep away from all these loud concerts, all these smoky places. They put fake fire. They put all those, their lights and everything. God said he's not there. Whenever God sees us reading the word of God, he comes. The Lord told me that. He comes. And I see him.
Yes.
I see him when I'm reading and I'm confused. He will tell me, check here, and everything will rhyme.
Yes,
the Lord is a teacher.
Yes,
he said, give attention to exhortation. Beware of prophecy time. Beware of all this shouting of preachers. Beware of all this anointing service. God is not there. Give attention to exhortation whereby we are reminding ourselves of the coming of the Lord.
Yes.
And then to doctrine that will give us character, that will give us direction on how to go. There's doctrine in marriage, there's doctrine about children, there's doctrine about your money, there's doctrine everything. Give attention to doctrine. Know the will of God. That's the essence of what is going to take us into heaven. Not he that said, Lord, Lord. So he came of heaven, but he that doeth doctrine of God. He that doeth the doctrine of God is the one that's going to enter heaven. So do not allow anybody on the full catechumens to deceive you about head covering, sister. Cover your head. If you are humble, cover it. If God is bigger than your head, cover it. If not, cancer is there. Don't joke with cancer. Cancer is finishing people. Even pastors' wives, they are going with cancer. Nobody's too much. Yeah, we are all to be humble before the Lord. He can use any means to take us home, but when God sees that we are proud, God Almighty will allow what's going to take that thing that's off you. Because of that, you see that hair, if you go to chemotherapy, it's gone. Because of that, even the wig, you'll be ashamed because there's some kind of wind that will blow that the wig will drop. And the bodo is going to shame. God will deliver us from shame.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The Bible says that there is something to look for. Where are you stopping? Are you stopping in verse 13? Child of God, seducing spirits are here. They are coming through, making it in life. They are mainly coming through preachers who expound and magnify money. They are coming through preachers who are talking about gifts and talents much more than us preparing for heaven. Seduction is everywhere. They are making us to feel that if you don't have certain things, you don't have faith. God is not with you. And anybody... I heard this same food card, Dejimo. I heard that she was saying yesterday they were when she went to America. So because so God understand, allow me to see these women who are spoiling his daughters. I need to see what they are doing so that their matter will be handled adequately.
Yes,
she said, they asked her, what are we going to expect in the next week? She said, it's grace. Grace makes things easy. Grace makes things. You will not struggle. You just be flying, gliding, enjoying. He said, grace removes suffering. Titus 2. Let's know that is what Bible say. Look at Titus 2. Let's talk about grace. She said grace is about grace to make everything easy. You will not struggle. You will not suffer. Because they put her inside the limousine. Look at grace. Titus 2, 11 to 15.
For the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared
to all men. The grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men.
Teaching us that. Denying ungodliness and worldly lusts.
Where is the enjoyment there? God says start with denial. Deny ungodliness
and worldly lusts. We should live soberly.
The Lord said be sober. This one said we should be flying and gliding. And that is the enjoyment of grace. He said live sober.
Righteously.
Be righteous.
And godly.
Live a godly life.
In this present world.
The Lord said this is what you should expect every time. Not evening service. In this present world,
looking for that blessed hope.
The Lord said, it's not a matter of things being easy. There's a blessed hope we should look forward to.
Yes, sir.
And
the glorious appearing of the great
we
God.
We should be expecting the coming of the Lord, the great God.
And our Savior, Jesus
Christ. Our Savior, Jesus Christ, the one that died on the cross. That's the one that we're going to see, the selfie of God.
Who gave himself for us?
The Lord said, Fuke Adetumo should preach about the cross. Not about enjoyment in this world, about things being easy. And when she said, they say, hey, mama, we love you, mama. Hey, mama, hey, oh, Lord, have mercy. The world is really lost. But God's going to rescue his own.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God Almighty said, you should finish up. Verse 15, what does it say?
Who gave himself for us? That he might redeem us from all iniquity.
That he might redeem us from such a sin in the matter. Grace came so that sin will be properly taken away. Iniquity will leave us. We don't want to be workers of iniquity at last.
And purify to himself a peculiar people.
Bible says good works. He that has this hope in him purifieth himself. We are going to purification.
Yes, sir.
Because it's not that we should be example in purity.
Yeah.
We are going to purification, child of God. Yes.
Zealous of good works.
Before we can begin to do the work of God.
This race we can exhort.
He's all said, Fuka Dejimo, and all these preachers all over the world, they should speak these things.
And exhort.
They should exhort. Nobody should go there and prophesy. Don't want to hear the prophecy. Go and teach and exhort.
And rebuke with all authority.
The Lord said, we rebuke him. When you see them going out, you rebuke them. Tell that man there to go back to his wife. He cannot go and remarry him. God Almighty said, it is time for them to put the truth.
Yes,
and not cover up for them.
Let no man despise thee.
Are you seeing that God is despising thing? You see, it's in Titus. We saw it in Timothy.
Yes.
God Almighty said, what you are doing is weird. Nobody can talk. He will bend their mouth. He will lock it with key and throw it in the sea. Beware of being afraid of men. Child of God, remember, utter, we don't fear anybody.
No.
But the mercy of God, provided it is God's word.
Yes.
We can fear if we are doing a false accusation. But if we are speaking God's word and what they have come to social media to do, we are not afraid of anybody.
Yes,
Why? The reason for social media is for the world to know what you are doing.
Yes, sir.
And I'm part of the world and I've seen what you are doing, and if it is contrary to my father, I'm going to speak.
Yes,
you can do this to yourself, but once you mention Jesus Christ, you have called the body of Christ.
Yes.
I have to follow you, Makosote. I cannot leave it like that. No, I have to speak something about it. Why? You have touched me. Tanaka, you have also touched my sister.
Yes.
You have touched my family.
Yes,
but I'm going to keep quiet.
Yes.
God Almighty said it's time for us to stand for Him.
Yes,
I will stand for this Bible.
I will stand for this Bible.
Bible believing is to be displayed for people to see as example.
Yes, sir.
I am an example of the believer.
Example
in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Some, we are going to read some scriptures, plenty, plenty, plenty.
Hallelujah.
We're going to read about the power of the word.
Hallelujah.
Should be up to 10 scriptures or more. Luke 11, 28. Somebody say Bible.
Bible.
Don't go away, child of God. The word of God is sufficient to keep us sitting.
Amen.
If Jesus was here physically, child of God, you cannot intercept. He will be talking. You saw it in Matthew 24. He entered 25. And now we have entered Matthew 5. He's still talking. So you must sit down. You cannot weep. Because when the word of God is coming, we goes to sit down and wait till the master is done. Beware people going to we, they go with phone. Once people go to we with phone, they are not really going to we. Hey, can I, they have a call. They want to reply a message. Hey, chalaga, yeah, no, they want to take a lead. They want to just relax a bit. They just want to watch a little video. Right? Because while preaching is going on, some churches, people are posting things.
Yes.
During preaching, Makosote, you want that discipline in church? Who's going to read it?
Luke 11:28.
Okay, Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12.
Yes, sir.
Hebrews 4, 12, this is the power of God's word.
Hallelujah.
2 Timothy 3, 16 and 17. These are scriptures of global altar.
Hallelujah.
Isaiah 40, verse number 8. Matthew 24, 35. Matthew 4, 4. Deuteronomy 8, 3, because we have to match scripture with scripture. Matthew 4:4, Deuteronomy 8:3, John 1:1 and 14, two verses in John 1, Psalm 33, verse number 4. Oh, Father, we give you glory.
Hallelujah.
Child of God, the reason why you need the word of God is because demons must go through process. People that have demons, they need the word of God. It's the word of God that goes to trouble demons. Child of God, people are managing demons because there's no word. That's so chalakalatia. Demons need to hear the word that they can be cast out. They bow. Remember, the demons tremble at his word. So without the word of God, child of God, demons cannot be activated and lubricated and ready to be cast out. So people are managing demons. Demons shouldn't be managed. They should be cast out.
Yes.
Beware of saying, I'm going for counseling when you need deliverance. Of course, because I'm saying, I'm going for counseling. The demon need the word. It's not what is word. And the word delivered them from their destructions. Demons came to destroy. They are not meant to be there. They should be cast out.
Wow.
So as this word is coming and entering us, child of God, demons are getting uncomfortable. All those seducing spirits that came to seduce us, they are getting confident. They're going to be cast out.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because you can use your mouth and cast them out. Bible says, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven.
In heaven.
Whatever you lose on earth shall be loose in heaven.
Yes,
whatever you cast out shall be cast out.
Amen.
God is calling us to be able to take authority.
Amen. Amen.
Don't go and carry demon and go and cast it away. The person has his own demons waiting. The Lord can have mercy on us. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Luke 11.
Luke chapter 11, yes. I read verse 28.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Amen.
That's all to swear.
But he said,
uh-huh.
Yea, rather,
uh-huh.
Blessed are they that hear the word of God
hallelujah.
And keep it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You should rather there. Yes. God Almighty said, blessed are those that hear the word. Are you hearing the word of God over there?
Yes, sir.
Are you blessed?
Yes.
You are blessed in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So you don't need any special blessing from anybody. Once you are hearing the word of God, you are already blessed.
Amen.
and your blessing shall remain.
Amen.
As you begin to practice the word,
Amen.
It shall be fulfilled.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Next verse.
Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12.
Yes, sir.
For the word of God is quick and powerful.
The word of God is quick, it's not slack, it's not slow. Yeah. It is quick and powerful.
And sharper than any two-edged sword.
It is a knife. It is a sword. It is sharper than any two-edged sword.
Piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and
child of God. When the word of God is coming, it doesn't pierce you. You didn't hear God's word. If God's word made you comfortable, you didn't hear his word. God's word must pierce. Somebody say pierce.
Yes.
It must enter where you didn't expect. It's just like when you are throwing an arrow and it's going like this, you don't know where it's going to enter. God's word, when it is coming, child of God, it should enter where God wants it to enter.
Yes.
Because you don't know where he's targeting. You only see an arrow coming. It can go and enter your mouth because your mouth is a problem. It's what is hindering your home. It can go and pierce your heart because your heart, that's where the problem is. It can go straight into your stomach. He knows what is there. God Almighty said, allow him to send his word. Don't direct the hand of God. He's not your medical doctor. Because of the that is in your hospitals, in the world here, that you tell them, touch me here and touch me there. They'll be asking a question. Is he paining you? God doesn't ask. He knows what is paining us.
Yes.
Lord, have mercy. That's why I cannot call a human being my doctor. Whenever I hear people say my doctor, and I say, who is the person? It's called one doctor, Kuru, called one doctor, he there. I say, child of God, your doctor is Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Oh, I can be doctor.
Yes,
I can be doctor. Jesus say na ba si akamba
doctor,
oh akamba
doctor,
akamba
doctor,
oh Jesus say na ba si akamba
doctor.
Son of God is our doctor.
Yes.
That's a song in Akwa Ibom language of Nigeria.
Hallelujah.
He's a great doctor.
Yes.
I don't need the doctors of this world.
Hallelujah.
Because those ones are apprentices. They don't even know nothing. They have to go and use rats to go and look for parts. And I say, God that made us.
Hallelujah.
It is what sharper. It pierces.
Even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit.
The Lord God Almighty goes to separate your soul, remove emotion, and let you know that what you are passing through is emotional. Put a demonic attack. And tell you what the one that is demonic attack. There's a God that gives us the root of problem through his word. There are some things that we are going through, child of God, it is not natural. It's spiritually induced. You do all the natural solution, it's not going. Like somebody thinks that some of our children are doing, it's not physical. So if you shout, your voice will crack. And anybody whose voice is cracked will get more angry.
Yes.
God bless you. And yet they have not changed. So your anger is doubling and then chest pain comes. He said the devil is there. No, child of God, you're pursuing spiritual thing with physical. They should be handled in the place of prayer.
Yes.
Take authority there and speak. And when you see them, be a lamp. Just if you're a fool. My son says, son, what's the matter, daughter? We have finished them inside there with prayer. And by telling them, they are going to bow. God is calling us to follow the word. Let it separate things.
Yes,
so we can finish well. He does what again?
Out of the joints and marrow.
God Almighty said he goes to things that we joined to. There is a God that to separate us. He will support us from some preachers.
Amen.
This is where we have got to put our backbone. See that your preacher that is your backbone, that's your prophet, that person that you cannot do without. God is going to separate us.
Amen.
He will disconnect us from evil things, but to be joined as with Christ.
Hallelujah.
Not to be joined to any human being. Child of God, God Almighty said, even husband and wife that you are joined together, death can separate them.
Yes.
Beware of being attached, so much attached to people and things, it has a way of affecting your destiny. Because even husband and wife that God has joined together, when it comes to God, there can be a separation. Yes, it's in the Bible. If somebody, the Bible says, the unbeliever will say, but let him depart. We are called to peace. We're not going to pursue him. We're not going to beg. We're not going to make efforts. That called to peace. We're not going to make efforts up and down that you must come back to me. No, we are called to peace. If he wants to go, let him go. It takes two to tango.
Sure.
Going to focus on my Jesus. People are friend after marriage. Child of God, you will commit sin. You will hate people. You will accuse people falsely. Maybe God, if something is not working, face the Lord. Allow him to solve your problem. Allow him to give you the peace that you need. Why am I talking about marriage? Many people are going through marital problems. So many, all over the world. I know the kind of counseling I get. And people are suffering. And God is saying, if you don't take care of this, I'm going to go to hell. Why? You are going to hate somebody. We have to follow peace with all men. This one is for somebody over there. Follow peace with all men. We talk too much and see God. Holiness is there, but this peace with all men, include your husband, include your wife. You must still love them. No matter what they have done, you must love them. Test yourself. Do you know how you're going to test yourself whether you love your wife, you love your husband? Who has maltreated you? Who has left you? Let them hear that there's a bad news about them. When you hear about the bad news about them, your reaction will tell us your heart. And if it is bad, you know what that means. God is calling us to a life of Christ through His word. Jerita Maru.
And He's a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart.
The Lord said His word can tell us, like now when I talked about He saw me today and the picture of my children, they're still confessing their sin. Why? God knows how to tell us what is in our hearts. He knows our motives. He judges the intent of our hearts. And He's calling us today to know that we cannot pretend. Child of God, you cannot hide sin. Nothing in this world can cover us. When God looks at us, He's sharper than scanning machine. God sees everything. He sees what is in us. He's a discerner of the thoughts and the intents
of
the heart. Allow God to search you. David allowed Him to search him. In Psalm 139. Look at Psalm 139. Look at the searching of God in the life of David. And that is why he loved David. David didn't have anything to hide. Before I go to the next verse, which is Timothy. Look at what he said, 23. Thank you. Psalm 139. Look at what he said in verse number 23. Psalm 139. Your hands are blessed.
Search me, O God.
Search me, O God.
And know my heart.
Know my heart.
Try me and know my thoughts.
Try me. Tell me, it's by His word that His word will come to pass. When the word of God coming to you is shukri, your heart cannot be tried. You cannot be searched. Child of God, they'll be saying what your ear wants to hear. God is after the hearts, not itching ear. He wants to enter the hearts where you'll be uncomfortable and be able to fall before the Lord and cry and repent of sin. Child of God, there's a revival coming.
Amen.
For those who believe God's word,
amen.
Whether it is physically, sugary or not, they believe God's word. Yes, I am one of them.
I am one of them.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Quickly read, son.
2 Timothy chapter
3:16-17.
All scripture is given by inspiration of God,
uh-huh.
and is profitable for doctrine,
yes.
for reproof,
yes.
for correction,
uh-huh.
for instruction in righteousness.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The word of God is for teaching. Beware of seduction again, child of God. This word is coming again. Beware of seductive slangs of preachers who justify sin, who make sin not to look very, very hard. Who makes it to look light? Who do not tell us about the consequence of sin? Beware of people who call sin mistake. Who call it compromise? Who call it sugary words that do not give the conviction that the word sin gives? I have sinned. It went from I have made a mistake. I made a mistake reduces the conviction and the power of repentance. Beware of words like God loves you even as you are. God is crazily in love with you. Chapter what? I see it. I hear it. God is so much madly in love with you that He cannot send you to hell. Beware of those words. They are slangs of the devil. God wants you to be happy. Beware of Jasmea. Ah, so Jaya. God wants you happy all the time. God wants you to have fun. Chapter what? This word. That's what Jasmea preaches. God wants you to have fun. Where's it in the Bible that God wants us to have fun? Why can't I have some fun? Yeah, yeah. You cannot have some fun. Be holy. Say yes, the Lord.
Yes.
No fun for us.
No
fun is closed. Yeah, Kala, because we can never have fun. Yeah, chalala. We are to enjoy what God gives to us.
Yes.
He never called it fun. It is false seductive preacher that called it fun. Who want to wear Gucci trousers, Gucci ring, Gucci belt, and all manner of Versace. God wants to come out of that designer perfume church people that are moving up and down. They are not following Him. Come out of what God cannot do, does not exist. These are seductive slangs of end time to pollute the hearts of people that are striving in holiness. I will not be corrupted, though.
I will not be corrupted.
I will not be modernized. If God wants us to be holy, I will maintain holy.
Yes,
I'm not going to be nice because God is not nice. God is holy. Beware of the word nice. That's nice. That's for your ice cream. That is for all your pizza and all your shawarma. That is not for my daddy God. Daddy God is solid. He's the one that gives all scripture. And he tells us as a father, the scripture I give to you is for what?
It's for doctrine. For reproof.
For reproof.
For correction.
For correction.
For instruction.
For instruction. That is a father talking. No, it's not our brother. My God, this is his father talking, not advising us. He's telling us what is his will.
Yes.
We must follow it. Any preacher who doesn't come in this direction is not of God. Beware of using old age to claim father in the Lord. This is our father. That is going to judge your father in the Lord. God said, follow it.
That the man of God
will
be perfect.
So that we'll be perfect.
Thoroughly furnished unto all good works.
Thoroughly furnished unto good works. Beware of nobody can be perfect. Everybody has one sin or the other. It's a lie. We can be perfect in God. We are bad when we stray. We repent. We turn looking for somebody to come and push us. That is perfection, family. That's perfection, family. When you err, when you sin, when you go astray, you quickly come out and identify and accept. That's how I train my children. I train them not to drag their leg, not to give the devil a chance to make them to be disobedient. Child of God, the aim of the devil is to make us get used to disobedience. Protect your hearts. Once you are used to disobedience, child of God, you will not know difference anymore. You will always assume that you're a Christian. Why? The gifts are coming of God. I will touch repentance. Because you can still pray, you can still read the Bible, you can still preach. You don't know that there's a disobedience. And every disobedience is a sin. Don't look down on disobedience, child of God. The enemy knows that backsliding is not one day. It is small, small. Somebody say small, small.
Small, small.
Backsliding consists of series of disobedience that you took lightly. A Bible believer does not want to have any hangover of sin. They want to deal with it instantly. Yes. Deal with sin, child of God. Don't push it. Don't postpone it. Don't say it doesn't really matter. Don't look for canceling of it. Sin is something that God made us to know that this is sin. Oh God, have mercy. Yes. The Lord said everybody in this world, once they sin, they know. Unless one has put themselves inside iron and have been seared with hot iron. That one that we not know. Yet they have no peace. It's the worldly peace that they have, and that peace of the world does not give them that security. That's why they still go and look for where they're going to put their hand to look for protection. God is calling us to beware of taking light disobedience. See this handkerchief? Put it here. And he put it here. It's disobedience. So you cannot weigh disobedience by using big sin as small sin. There's no little disobedience in the Bible. Disobedience is disobedience. So what's your understanding?
Understanding.
If you do not have this understanding, you will joke with some things in your life. I don't know the one that God is checking. He's looking for a church without blemish, without spots, without wrinkle, or any such thing. Child, have you ever ironed silk before? Have you ironed silk? And it was straight? Fold it and keep it in the cupboard. Bring it out. It has changed. It has wrinkled. It has rumpled. There's no dirt, but it is no longer like before. We must daily check, examine ourselves whether we're in faith. Whether we're still believing in perfection. Whether we still believe in holiness. Whether we still believe that there's a heaven. Because many have not yet agreed. I heard somebody was saying that heaven is in this world and it is to enjoy. Lord, if you see what the devil is doing to Christians, especially abroad, many people abroad don't believe that there's heaven. In America, London, which heaven? Yeah, their heaven is here. My God, their green card is their heaven. They have already their planning. Somebody called me this morning. I said, hey, God bless you. I said, hey, I want to invite you for a program. I said, hey, when? He said, 2022. I said, 2022? I said, we are still in 2021. And we're in November 10. He said, he knows I am busy. I said, no, that time has passed. I live one day at a time. I said, keep calling me as Jesus tarries, when we are getting there, if the Lord says we should come, we will come. Child of God, be worth saying I'm fully booked. Somebody come and know me, say, they're booked. This group, they're popular. They're the reigning group now. They've booked them till February next year. I say, Lord, have mercy on this with this black ignorant. If you know that the next second does not belong to them.
Yes.
The next second is not promised. Uh-huh. That's why God quickly said there's a life to come. Just in case you go now. There's a life to come. Prepare for that one.
Yes.
He never promised anybody next second. So be well planning for the next birthday. He was saying, I will soon be 50, I will soon be 60, I will soon be 40. Child of God, we don't know. Life belongs to God.
Yes, sir.
Naked we came, naked we are living. Beware of your prideful plans. Always put if God permits,
yes,
if Jesus tarries, yes, if he keeps on keeping us. I'm so used to it that nobody can push me. I must talk it. I'm not afraid to die, but I am not the owner of life. I give God all the glory. He's the owner of our lives. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So what is the next scripture?
Isaiah chapter 40, verse 8.
Thank you.
The grass withereth,
uh-huh,
the flower fadeth,
uh-huh,
but the word of our God shall stand forever.
Hallelujah! God's word stands forever.
Yes.
Unchanging word. Nobody can modernize it. It remains the ancient words, ever true,
yes, sir,
that can change your heart and change my heart. God Almighty said that is the word that we are standing for. So we keep on believing to the end.
Amen.
Next verse.
Matthew chapter 24.
Verse 35.
Matthew 24, 35.
Yes, sir.
Heaven and earth shall pass away,
uh-huh,
but my words shall not pass away.
Hallelujah! Heaven and earth shall pass away, but Jesus never... That's that song. Jesus never
fails.
The word of God. That's the word of God. The word of God can never pass away. And remember the song for me. What is heaven and earth shall pass away, but the word never will never fail. Abi, hallelujah. These my children. God will help them to understand.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You know, when our ministry song will just come into my spirit, man. Yes. Child of God, God Almighty is saying that his word will never pass away.
Mm-hmm.
Heaven, not even, not talking about America or London. Heaven shall pass away.
Hallelujah.
That's a new heaven.
Hallelujah.
Coming down.
God Almighty says he's going to bring his heaven.
Amen.
And a new earth,
amen,
which we are coming to reign for 1,000 years.
Amen.
This world shall pass away. So all of you are doing the graveside of your loved one, and you are putting all manner of magnesium, all manner of marble. They're going to be melted down. Yeah, Kalantaya. Stop wasting money for graves.
Yes, sir.
Stop covering graves. For if that person is a child of God that they're putting inside there, when the dead in Christ, when the trumpet shall sound, it shall blast open. It shall scatter. You'd have used the money to go and make the work of God, his righteous cause, and go and save souls. We will not regret in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What's the next verse?
Matthew chapter 4.
Matthew 4:4. Did you tell me 8:3? Quickly, sir.
But he answered and said,
uh-huh,
it is written,
it is written,
man shall not live by bread alone.
Man shall not live by bread alone.
But by every word that proceeded out of the mouth.
But by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of the Lord. So there's a reference point in Deuteronomy 8:3. Because they said, it is written.
Yes.
Child of God, this is how you read the Bible.
Yes.
Once you hear it is written, go and look for the reference.
Yes.
To confirm it, the mouth of two or three witnesses, the word is established. So what does it say? Deuteronomy 8:3.
Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 3.
Yes.
And he humbled thee,
uh-huh,
and suffered thee to hunger,
uh-huh,
and fed thee with manna.
Are you hearing?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Which thou knewest not,
uh-huh,
neither did thy fathers know,
uh-huh,
that he might make thee know that man doth not live by bread
man
only.
Man doth not live by bread only,
but by every word that proceedeth out of the
mouth of the Lord. But by every, we must look for that every word.
Mm.
Not the one we like. It's not a buffet. Not a pick and choose. Every word that proceeded out of the mouth
of the Lord.
Hallelujah. That's what we need.
Yes,
and that's what we are going to eat.
Amen.
Beware of saying, what am I going to eat tomorrow? How will my tomorrow be? How will my future be? If we do not know. There's a Jeremiah 29:11. Before I go to the next verse. There's a Jeremiah 29:11 that we are walking with. And God has not changed.
Yeah.
Yes, we are believers. I believe Jeremiah 29:11.
Jeremiah 29:11.
What does it say?
For I know the thoughts that I think towards you.
For I know the thought that I think towards you.
Saith the Lord.
Saith the God.
Thoughts of peace.
Thoughts of peace.
And not of evil.
Not of evil.
To give you an expected.
To give you. To put your name there.
To give things.
To give you an expected end. Child of God, this verse is loaded.
Hallelujah.
This verse that there's going to be an end. And that the expectation of that end that me and you are favored of God.
Hallelujah.
We are going to see the glory of God.
Hallelujah.
Because we're going to believe what God has said. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What's the next verse?
John chapter 1, verse 1.
Hallelujah.
In the beginning was the Word.
Yes.
And the Word was.
In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Oh, in the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Therefore, this says, and the Word
was
made
flesh.
The Word was made. So the magician did not become. I used to think that it was become. It was made.
Flesh.
It did not become. You know the bracatabra.
It
was made.
Flesh.
There is a God that entered song.
Yes.
That is the word that people are using to call Trinity.
Yes.
It did not become. It was made.
And dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory.
And we beheld his glory.
Glorious of the only begotten of the Father. Full of grace and truth.
Full of grace and truth. Child of God, this is why he came. John 1:17 says so.
For the law was given by Moses. But grace and truth came by Jesus.
Hallelujah. So the word was given his name in verse 17.
Yes,
the name was now mentioned in verse number 17. That the name is Jesus Christ. Why? He is the begotten, the only begotten
of the Father.
Of the Hallelujah. He was made child of God. I didn't know. I don't know what he became. He now says he's not a magician. He's a processing God. Nobody's going to accuse him. So God is showing us that there's no Trinity. He's the one that was made flesh. Right? He used the word. He spoken word. He turned it into the house of Mary. And put in her his seed. So Joseph could not touch the word. Because there's already flesh there. God Almighty is calling us to come out of religion and be spiritually minded. Will of God is spirit. Child of God, you want of God is spirit. God had to make it flesh. So we can behold it. We can see it. Who was it that said, behold the Lamb of God? Was it John? Behold the Lamb of God, which taketh the sin of the world. God Almighty is faithful. We are beholding. We are still going to behold him. Face to face, we shall behold him. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God Almighty said that is the power of the world. And when they are forced, you are throwing away your Bible and carrying phone. Child of God, go back to your Bible. There's a difference between carrying Bible and carrying handset. There's a respect. There's a glory that comes on you when you carry your Bible. Don't allow the devil to deceive you with these preachers. God cannot be modernized. It's called the book of the law. And his name, child of God, is the beginning and the end. So he was at the end, telling us carry book. He went to the end to say carry book. He is not slack. He is not old. He is quick.
Yes.
He is sharp. Only quite sharp. Yes, sir. Good job. Papa is sharp. Who are you learn sharp from? He is a sharp.
Yes.
And he said it's through his word.
Yes,
sir. Child of God, my heart is full of joy. Because I have this word.
Yes, sir.
You can't take it though. It's untakeable. Take the whole world. Leave me with my word.
Yes,
I'm going to enjoy my Jesus.
Hallelujah.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Psalm 33,
verse
4.
For the word of the Lord is right. All his works are done in truth.
Hallelujah. Tell God, if all his works are done in truth, I am his work.
I am his work.
I am done in truth.
I am done in truth.
So I cannot lie. I have to enjoy truth. Sanctify them through their truth. They go all is truth. Tell God, if you don't love this word of God, we are lost. I cannot deceive you. While this word is not to you, pray on your body. Child of God, you don't know him. I don't know what has collected you, but you're coming back today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God Almighty is going to help you now.
Amen.
He's talking to us today again that the devil is coming with seduction. The same way a man called Elijah, who single-handedly destroyed 850 prophets of Baal, what happened to him in 1 Kings 19? A man that was so solid, a man that was that outran a chariot, a man that did not give up the place of prayer, that bent his head in the most uncomfortable way to pray. Makoso Talagaya, what happened in 1 Kings 19? Seduction came. Read 1 to 4. 1 Kings 19, 1 to 4.
And yes. Ahab told Jezebel all that Elijah had done.
Ahab went to tell his wife, the king went to tell his wicked wife Jezebel what Elijah had done.
And withal, how he had slain all the prophets with the sword.
He gave him story.
Then Jezebel sent a messenger unto Elijah, saying, So let the gods do to me and more also, if I make not thy life as the life of one of them tomorrow, about this time. And when he saw that, he arose. And went for his life.
Yes.
And came to Beersheba,
which
belongeth to Judah, and left his servant there. But he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness.
Are you seeing what happened to a prophet? That prayer warrior, fire caller, look at it.
And came and sat down under a juniper tree. And he requested for himself that he might die. And said, it is enough now, O Lord. Take away my life, for I am not better than my father.
Child of God, beware of thinking your preacher is too much. Nobody is too much for the devil. God is going to know that a preacher can need deliverance. A child of God, we can need deliverance. Why? Demonic suggestion. We cannot allow evil dream. Child of God, when you wake up from an evil dream, the devil suggested something. When they pressed your neck in the night, it was a suggestion.
Yes.
When you saw something that they came to do to you in the dream, it was a suggestion. You cannot allow it.
Yes.
It must be dealt with.
Yes.
You cannot just say, the blood of Jesus. No, you have to handle it with prayer.
Yes.
You have to be violent. You have to be angry because an arrow has come. Look at it, sir. Before we conclude this Elijah matter, look at Psalm 91.
Yes.
Look at arrow there, verse 5. Look at Psalm 91, verse 5.
Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor the arrow that flieth by day.
Child of God, the devil sends arrow, and arrows carry infection. It brings wound. It brings wound. The Lord said, every Christian, don't ignore where you are being hit. It can be with words. Don't look down on it. Elijah heard word from a wicked woman, Jezebel, and he's going to act the way he did in chapter 18. Look at the difference between 18 and 19.
Yes.
What happened to the power suddenly? What's wrong with him? He that taketh his time should take heed lest he falls. There are times that the enemy will come with terrorism, come with seduction, to bring weakness, to challenge you. And I thought you don't have to pray. Are you praying now? Tell him, say yes, I'm going to pray. And I bind you, I resist you. Don't allow the devil to go away. Whenever you notice yourself that you're getting weak and they wake you up to pray, don't get angry. Child of God, not all sleep came from God. He gives us a little bit of sleep. So when you find yourself sleeping during prayer, it's not from the Lord. That is only one day. There's an enemy. There's an evil suggestion. There's an evil wind. Yeah, there's a wand of the devil. That's why people are preachers who carry magic wand. Yeah, the enemy has done some wands. He has done some things with his magical wand. All these gospel singers, you see, a lot of them money to celebrity, they have wands. Why did I ask you, Magic Johnson? My cousin there, they have magic wands. God Almighty said it is time for us to know that the devil comes with enchantments to seduce us. Suddenly you begin to hate holiness. It's not ordinary. Suddenly you are tired of what used to excite you about God. Suddenly you do not want to see certain holiness people like me.
suddenly.
Once they want to see me again, devil has come. Why? He doesn't want you to hear what is going to pierce you. Anyone of God, you hear and you find yourself bending your head, God is the one talking. God is speaking something to you. That head bending is not ordinary. It is time for you to know that you should walk on that area. Nobody gossip anybody. Hey, God said that area that made you to feel ashamed. Walk on it. The devil is going to hold on to it. Satan has one sin per Christian. You know sin that will catch you. He knows our sin.
Yes.
And he knows what will make us not to attack it. Some of us, he will give us food. Some is promotion in the office. Some of us is his blessing. Sudden pregnancy. Child of God, beware, sister. You are sorry to pray. You are having pregnancy. Only Jesus will pray for you. Some of us is sudden blessing will come. Why? The devil wants something that will make you so occupied that you will not attack what you send you to hell. It is called seduction. Before I fought the Lord that done for me, I cannot tell it all. Suddenly you'll be too busy, Lord. You know I'm tired. Angel Michael, please pray for me over there. You begin to pay for prayer. Lord God have mercy. Have mercy on me in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Pray for yourself. There are arrows that must be dealt with. Don't ignore them. Don't look down on them. The devil is called a strong man. He's not ordinary, and he's still here. No song can match the devil. Said that don't fall for God. Matcha. He's not matched. Why? You don't know whether he has left your leg since. He may not be here. He may have been gone. He has gone since. You didn't know that he has gone to Moscow. He's not even here. So are you matching him? Lord, how mercy on my ignorance. We have been so ignorant that we thought that the devil was cohabiting with us. The devil cannot be everywhere at the same time. Only God is omnipresent. Satan is in one place at a time. But he has his lieutenant and all his demons that he sent on errands. And child of God, man is going to know that if you say Satan, don't over God, much man, it's a demon. The demon will not go. His name is not Satan. His name may be lie. Spirit of lie. Spirit of loss. See, I don't call this name. Oh, God, have mercy on me. Child of God, beware of songs that make you feel like they're killing devil. He didn't go nowhere. He's there with his work. Elijah received a message from a deadly woman and kept and decided to fight God. Beware, Father, why me? Upon what I'm doing, don't you see nothing good in me? Child of God, face the devil. Shut the door against him.
Yes, sir.
Stop going to fight your daddy. My God, sir, there. Because daddy has given you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. And he said nothing. Shabba, so my enemies hold you. That is Luke 10:19. God is calling us to stand on his word. It's infallible word. I am a Bible believer. And I believe that word. In the name of Jesus Christ. God Almighty said, Elijah forgot prayer. When you begin to forget prayer, there's a demon responsible. He began to face God. That was his deliverer. He forgot testimony. Don't forget testimony. Oh, when I remember what the Lord has done, I will never go back anymore. When I remember what the Lord has done, I will never go back anymore. No. Testimonies. Remember where God has brought you from, child of God, and stay with God. Remember the prayer that He answered the other day, Makoso there. Has He ever answered a prayer one day in your life?
Yes.
God Almighty said He will answer it again. Oh, God can do it again. All again, all again. He's the same God today as He always has been yesterday and today. When Bible believers we gather like this, we sharpen ourselves. We rebuke ourselves. We say, don't do that. Don't do that. You cannot do that. You cannot betray our Father and our culture there. That is the essence of Bible believers gathering together. When you are in the midst of unbelieving believers, child of God, there's chaos and fight. But if all of us believe the Bible, we will all see it together. God Almighty wants us to follow this direction. I will not miss the gathering of Bible believers.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Beware of preachers telling you look for a Bible believing church. They are calling themselves that. Once you hear a preacher say, you don't need to come here and look for any Bible believing church, they are lying. They are introducing themselves to you. Makoso Tanami, that they are the Bible believing church. God Almighty say, if you don't believe in church, you will not see the women leaving their hair open. You will not see the women painting and wearing trousers. Makoso there. If you believe in church, the pastor's wife cannot sit with him there and they'll be kissing. You cannot see the pastor's wife carrying cloths to cover her dress on the altar. That's why Bible believing church. My cousin there.
Yes.
Bible believing church, they do things decently and in order. God is the one honor. They don't do bad day there. My cousin there. God is the one that they recognize. I was so shocked that the man that said general overseer of the world, Paul Rica, he was this 60th birthday. People are wishing him happy birthday. I was ashamed of Christians that were going to wish him happy birthday. I thought he's general overseer of the whole world. Look at morning, because God say he's not in birthday. But G.O. of the world is in doing birthday. Who is the G.O. who should be in someone's G.O.? Me, his G.O. or he, my G.O.? I have left birthday. He's still in birthday. Child of God, God Almighty said, look at all the apostles in the scripture. They didn't do birthday one day. Come for it in history. They were looking for death day. This one said, I want to die upside down on the cross. This one said, let them cook me inside pots. This one said, let me die falling from here. Child of God, until you become one quarter of these apostles that died for Jesus Christ, we are not yet qualified for heaven. Why? They are not to heavens. They are not going there. I will not go there and feel inferior. God Almighty said it's time for us to stand with the people that believe the Bible and follow their way.
Yes,
they believed against hope. They hazarded their life. We're going to read that scripture again today. We're going to read that scripture again in Acts chapter 15, 25 and 26. They hazarded their lives because of the gospel. Acts 15, 25 and 26. We read it last night.
Yes,
read it again.
It seemed good unto us, being assembled with one accord,
yes,
to send chosen men unto you with our beloved.
Somebody say chosen men.
Chosen men.
Not the Lord chosen, no. Not that church called the Lord chosen. This will have chosen generation, chosen of God, just like you and I, we are the chosen generation.
Hallelujah.
A real priesthood. Hallelujah.
Men that have hazarded their lives.
Put their life on the line. Put their life in danger because of Jesus Christ. Because of God's work, they believe. Hey, Galatia, these are believers. God Almighty said there are men who have sold their lives to the gospel because of Jesus Christ. That is why we are going to see Romans 1, 16, son. These are scriptures that God Almighty gave us last night in our prayer. And God said He has not finished with those scriptures. This is our foundation.
For I am not ashamed of the gospel.
He is not ashamed.
Of the gospel of Christ.
Of the gospel of Christ. The anointed one with the anointing.
Hallelujah.
For
it is the power of God unto salvation.
God Almighty said, our foundation is the power of God.
Unto salvation.
Unto salvation, not prosperity, not money, not blessing. Unto salvation.
To everyone that believeth.
I am a believer. Towards everyone that believes. Child of God, use it and judge preacher. Mm-hmm. Any preacher that does emphasize on salvation is not displaying the power of God. Any preacher who talks about anointed oil, anointed water, anointed handkerchief, all those things, they are not operating with the power of God. Because they are still talking about salvation. They are talking about things, talisman. They want you to believe in them. Anybody who uses handkerchief for a preacher cannot believe in God. Anybody who uses a preacher gift to you, you can never believe in God. All your belief will be actually when I was worshiping the dead TB Joshua. Yeah, because he used to give them talisman. Child of God, beware of all these people that are doing deliverance and making people to look like. I saw a deliverance of David Biumi of Port Harcourt. Yeah, he told three men to line up, strong, hefty men, and then he would say he wants to describe grace. He now called a little girl, a slim girl, someone as small as this my Zion, and that one stood and was facing three men. He now told her, push the three men. She tried, of course, she couldn't push three men. He now said, now I'm going to show you how grace works. He told her, lift your hand. Now focus, meditate on my words. Focus. Don't think of anything. Just focus. I saw the video. So she did like this and focused. She said, now push. The girl did like this. The three men fell. Oh, yeah. Abracadabra. Come and see. American wonder. Come and see. Port Harcourt wonder. Oh, yeah. Port Harcourt wonder. Salvation ministry wonder. Beware of that man. That man is operating with witchcraft powers. Let him come and meet me. We are in Port Harcourt together. David Ipiomi. Share to him. He's operating with witchcraft power. How did he make that girl to push three men? She says, Chris. He called it Chris. And they were not acting drama. No. It was not acting. He said the girl should focus on what he is saying. Tell her God, we focus on Jesus, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, not on the words of a preacher. She pushed the three hefty men down. The men were shocked. They were on the floor. He said, how come? He said, this is grace. The whole church said, hey, I receive. Men are lost. They are blinded. The gospel is hid to them. They are seeing a man that I want your grace. God anointed me for prosperity. Show me the scripture. There is nobody here that God anointed for prosperity. Even King Solomon was not anointed for prosperity. We've seen it in the scripture. We've already seen the secret in 1 Kings 3. His prayer pleased God. He didn't ask for all those things. And God said, I'm going to give it to you because I just want you to know that I am happy with you. Hey, God, the Lord have mercy. Beware of such sugary, false, seductive preachers. They are all over the world. And their names will be mentioned. If they deny it, let them come. God is going to sit on who is speaking the truth. I'm not afraid. God will sit on whoever is speaking the truth. He will confirm it. It is power. The power of God unto salvation. That is the gospel of Jesus Christ. Not all those things that people are carrying up and down. Not all the crowded program. Crowd does not determine God's presence. If not, we're not going to Paul and Silas in the prison. He will not go and pick up Lazarus. Crowd does not determine how God favors a man. For all I care, crowd is a sign of the Broadway. That leads to destruction. God Almighty said it's time for us to stand for him and resist the devil. Resist him. In every ramification, resist him. Don't allow him to seduce you. Your soul is precious. I'm going to pray. But God Almighty said there's gospel. There's word for us. Yes, we're not going to be lost in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The word of God is called the bread. It's the bread of life. Go to the book of John. John chapter number 6:58 and then Matthew 6:11. John 6:58, Matthew 6:11. Oh, Daddy, we give it glory.
Hallelujah.
John chapter 6, verse 58.
Uh-huh.
This is that bread which came down from heaven.
Uh-huh.
Not as your fathers did eat manna and are dead.
Uh-huh.
He that eateth of this bread shall live forever.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God told me I had to write it down. He said, Nkechi, the word of God is bread. Satan also told the world to call money bread. The world calls money bread. You get bread. When you hear the word say, do you have bread? They mean you have money. They call money bread. Have you not heard it before? If you heard it, they call money bread. And that means you are very holy. Holy people don't know. The real worldly people, kings, don't you know? You should know. Kings, Remember school life, eat the pot. Don't students call money bread? I cannot tell. They call it many things. They call it K. Give me 5K. Give me bread. They call money bread. That is what made people to worship money. Mammon. Students, youths, they call it bread. I've been hearing it. Maybe because I'm older in this generation. My generation. They call it bread. How many old people are there? It's my grandmother, they confirm. Anybody is old there from 50 up, they call money bread in the world. God Almighty said his word is bread. And it's not a once in a while bread. How many times do we eat the bread? Matthew 6:11. How many times? Read Matthew 6:11, sir.
Matthew 6:11. Give us this day our daily
bread. Give us this day our daily bread. Child of God, the reason why we need it every day is because the devil is going to attack anybody holding this bread. Once you are holding this bread of life, get ready for attack. Devil must attack it. Why? He wants us to prove and confirm if truly we believe. He's going to attack our belief system. He's going to attack our faith. Beware of the word that they say, finished work of Christ. Did not say satanic word. Is it finished work of Christ? It is satanic word though. Did not say it is finished. People added finished work of Christ. There's nothing like finished work of Christ in the Bible. It's human beings that added it. So people can be saying. So I saw a WhatsApp status of a youth who had been meeting me that he's struggling with fornication and immorality. So he came to me, I saw his WhatsApp and said, hey, let me now begin to enjoy my finished work of Christ. I said, son, come here. Finished work of Christ? From where? Sin is coming. He said, yes, for me, it's true. Mommy, good afternoon.
Yes.
Child of God, I cannot keep quiet and allow that word, finished work of Christ, to continue in the life of the people of God.
Amen.
What am I saying? Stop it.
Yes,
finished work of Christ, people are making it license for sin.
Yes.
License to dress as you like. The God sees the heart. The dressing doesn't matter. Yes, it's because of that finished work of Christ that they're quoting. They use it to say these people to begin to dress worldly. So you see people who are dressing godly, they say, what is it? All this is your dressing. God is not seeing it. He's seeing your heart. He's seeing your heart. Yet this same God, when he wants to describe himself, he's not with his dressing.
Yes.
He himself judges himself first with his dressing. How much more we mere mortals? Child of God, these are seductive slangs that if Jesus tarries on this global altar, we'll keep on highlighting them. To come out of them. Because God said it's happening in our time.
Yes.
Seductive doctrines of credit alert on phone. What do they have? Money alert. These are all seductive things that are happening. What is enemy, fall and die? They are all seductive things. God Almighty is calling us to become Bible believers. Not seduction of churches. That is why the Lord left the temple in March 24 to come and prepare us for his coming. Because he's coming.
Yes, sir.
He is coming.
Hallelujah.
And God Almighty said he's going to look out for as many as wearing the garment of the gospel unto salvation. Because we believe. And as we're going to begin to prepare now to pray, child of God, God Almighty said, go to the book of Mark 13. Go to the book of Mark 13. Before you go to Mark 13, there's a scripture in Genesis 3. Go to Genesis chapter 3, 4 to 5. So that you will see that this seduction didn't start today. It began with the devil when he was talking to sister Mama Eve.
Read Genesis it. Chapter 3.
Uh-huh.
I read from verse 4.
Yes.
And the serpent said unto the woman,
uh-huh,
ye shall not surely die.
Yes.
For God doth know that in the day ye eat thereof,
uh-huh,
then your eyes shall be opened,
uh-huh,
and ye shall be as God,
uh-huh,
knowing good and evil.
Child of God Almighty said, it is time for us to know that this world is still there. People that Satan is challenging God and making things to look easy. Don't worry, how can God kill you? You will not surely die. God knows that the day you will eat, you will not be like, you don't want to be like God. God will be happy even if you see that you are like him. Beware of seductive, sugary words. Because now, preachers are coming up to say, like, what is his name? Abel Damina. He said that the way God punishes unbelievers who commit fornication and adultery is not how he punishes Christians. That is fornication and adultery. That is the way God punishes Christians. It's different from unbelievers. I don't know whether he has not in Revelation chapter 21, verse 8. I don't know. But let us look at this verse in Luke. Is it Mark? I mentioned Mark 13. Look at verse number 2 and 6. Is 5 and 6. 2, 5, 6. We've read chapter 34.
2, 5, and 6. And Jesus answered and said unto him, Seest thou this great building? There shall not be left one stone upon another that shall not be thrown down.
Child of God, be one big building. Because yesterday I saw Polynesia. He came out in a video saying, have you been to my dome? I said, they began to show the dome in the night. You know, when the place is lighted up in the night, people is looking at Sodom and Gomorrah. Everybody was looking beautiful. The Lord didn't hide it from us. There are glories in this world. And it's called Glory Dome. It's called Glory Dome. Have you been to my dome? Have you been to this place? He was advertising his dome. Child of God, many people are carried away by the dance steps of preachers. They don't know they are dancing because of the crowd. The more crowd, the more money. Most of the dances of preachers is not because they love God. They are counting the per head. It's called per head, PH. They are cutting head. The more head, the more money. Be one branch opening. Because many people are not following God, they are following dollar, euro, pound sterling, yen. What is the Dubai? Time to buy money there. They are following currency. They're not following God's current means of salvation. God Almighty said, you see all those they are building, that they are building, they are fought for the auditorium, that you are putting your money yet, it's not working for you. You are sitting with a bad child, maybe I'm thinking. God Almighty said, they will be thrown down. I will never invest in such buildings. It's a wasted investment. Child of God, whatever we can find to gather to serve God, if there is no, because of the weather condition, rain or whatever, it's okay. There's a mansion we're going for. We're going to use the money to invest in the life of people. We are soul builders. Like I'm trusting God for a place for my widows. For me to be able to fellowship with the widows. Because of COVID-19, we lost where we normally use. And God is going to make a way for us.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord said every building is going to come down. What does verse 5 say?
Verse 5, and Jesus answering them began to say,
yes,
take it lest any man deceive you.
Take it lest any man deceive you. Seducers are everywhere. They are preachers, overseers, bishops that are stashing money in foreign currencies, in companies, buying shares. God is exposing them now. God Almighty said, all the big churches you see, they are business centers. Their children are the board of trustees. Are you not seeing synagogue? The wife has taken over. She is not general overseer, whatever she calls herself, dear. The most important thing is that she has taken over as a woman over the church. It's an abomination. It's an abomination. So she's not allowed to take charge. Write it somewhere. Remember the numbers for us. I write it somewhere. We're going to read it. Who should be over church? These are seductions. Don't forget some 27 numbers. Is that your scripture? Number 27. I hope you remember it's 16. Verse 16. Now finish up this verse number 6.
For many shall come in my name, saying.
Somebody say many.
Many.
Child of God, there are people that are calling Christ. Doesn't mean that they are of God. Many shall come in his name, saying,
I am Christ.
I am Christ. And what will happen?
I shall deceive many.
Child of God, we've done Bible study, but God said, keep on talking about this. Because many have been deceived. They shall deceive many. Many. When God says many, it is many.
Yes.
Nobody is going to come and say, I am devil. They are going to come and say, I am Christ. They are going to bring out Bible. They are going to talk about holiness. They are going to look humble. But they are going to deceive many. And they are going to follow them. But you and I will not follow them.
Amen.
These are the seductions of the last days that only Bible believers are going to escape. And we shall escape them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Be so that we can begin to
pray. Numbers 27, 16 and 17.
Yes.
Let the Lord. The God of the spirits of all flesh.
Look at who should choose, who should head church.
The Lord.
It is the Lord.
The God of the spirits of all flesh.
He is the God of the spirits of all flesh.
Set a man over the congregation.
No, set the wife of the general overseer.
A man.
Set their son.
A man.
A man can be anybody.
Yes.
set a man
over the congregation.
Over the congregation.
Which may go out before them.
Who will be the one to go like Jesus did when he saw the mountain in Matthew 5, go up to the mountain and go and pray to receive message for the people?
And which may go in before them.
Yes.
And who may lead them out.
And the one that is going to preach to them until they make heaven at last.
And bring them in.
Yes.
And the congregation of the Lord be not as sheep with no
hands. Holy Ghost says, explain that. Bring them out of worldliness and bring them into the throne of grace.
Hallelujah.
Send them to heaven. What does he say? 17. Read 17.
That the congregation of the Lord be not as sheep which have no shepherd.
Hallelujah. Not shepherdess.
No
shepherdess. Child of God, shepherd is for man.
Yes.
Because if he says shepherd is not for man, you are giving the female gender to God.
Mm-hmm.
And God cannot be a female gender.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is my shepherd. So when you are shepherd, it is a man. So Mrs. Evelyn Joshua is there deceiving the crowd because he wants to maintain the partnership of their family business and to make more money. I pity everybody under her. They are all going to hellfire. I didn't say so. God's word condemned them. Because God said this is a man that will bring them out of worldliness and send them into heaven. Child of God Almighty is calling us to be humble. The word of God coming from the global altar is not coming from a church system. This is the word of God coming forth as a judgment against the devil and against the sins that is perpetrated in the life of the people of God. And to call us out to revival and to the place of prayer.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Before we begin to pray, Abel, that we now say fornicators have two types of punishment. God said, confirm it. Revelation 21:8. Let's confirm it here. Confirm it in Revelation 21:8. Whether we have two types of fornicators, one for believers, one for unbelievers. That's what he said. Read.
But the fearful.
Revelation 21:8.
But the fearful.
The fearful.
And unbelieving.
Unbelieving. Are you seeing, child of God? Are you seeing unbelieving there?
Yes.
I will never be an unbeliever.
I will never be an unbeliever.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The unbelieving.
And the abominable.
The abominable, the transgender, all those that do not want to separate male and female. God must say the abominable, all those that are going about doing all kinds of liposuctomy, all kinds of things that people are doing in the world, preaching their skin, wearing all the seductions. God must say all these, they are piercing of nose, piercing of everywhere, piercing of eye, they are abominable things.
Abominable. And murderers. And whoremongers.
Whoremongers, all the immorality in the world, child of God, these days you have seen that husband, men say they want to marry their daughters and vice versa.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I saw a pastor in Nigeria, she said it is righteousness for brother-in-law to sleep with his late brother's wife. That's not a sin. My God, that God Almighty said nothing is wrong with it. It's to maintain the wife in the home. So that she will not leave. So the brother-in-law can sleep with her. He's a pastor in Nigeria. Hey, Kalanta Lagaya. Abominable things. These are wicked people. Homongous.
And sorcerers.
Sorcerers, burning on fire. My God, fall and die. These are sorcerers. Anybody that is holding my blessing, die. These are witches and wizards. Speaking to the dead, shaving your hair for the dead. You are a sorcerer. You are somebody dying, you shave your hair. You are a sorcerer. Why are you shaving hair? To give them money to spend in the land of the dead.
My Lord.
Kalebo Kosucha, you are a sorcerer. Hey, Lord, have mercy.
Idolaters.
God of people, God of Fulikaya, God of the, if he tries God of Justine, he will not even agree. America, they don't like that one. It's Africa that like God of things. Necromancers, witchcraft pastor. Any person that likes you to put his name with God is fighting with God. It's an idolater. It's an idol worshiper. It's an idol.
Mm-hmm.
Beware, child of God, of God attributing God to a human being. The only human beings he put his name with in the everlasting is a covenant family.
Yes.
God of Abraham and of Isaac and of Jacob. That is where he put it in Exodus 3:15. That's the end. Don't add it to another person. Finish up.
And all liars.
So say all liars.
All liars.
All the people are prophesying. That's what they call himself. He called himself and he said there will be no election in Nigeria now, but there's election, people won.
Yeah.
Beware of false prophets. they pray, because that's how you know them. Their prophecy doesn't come to pass, and they come and say, I'm not really a prophet. I'm just an ordinary pastor. You have them, why you prophesy? Because it didn't come to pass. Beware of those who fix dates. I said, the man fixed dates before he died. He said that when you gave up dates, he was talking about dates when COVID-19 will stop. He didn't stop. Now he has left. Now you can't meet God. You tell God when God told him that COVID-19 is going to end. Lord God Almighty, deliver us from false prophets.
Amen.
They are all liars. When you are dark, you change it to white with cream. It's called lightning cream. You are a liar. When your eyebrow is like my own, it's almost ash. You go and add it black. You are a liar. When you have gray hair like me here, you go and darken it and put red and put gold and put all manner of colors. You are a liar.
All liars,
child of God. When you go and color your nail, God made it white, you put it red, you're a liar. Whatever you are doing to your body that God Almighty did not approve you to do, you have lied. There are certificate liars, there are marital liars. All of you in abroad that you have got to marry somebody to get paper. Hey, after you go behind and divorce, you're getting paper. You're a liar, you are married. Ah, Kalibo Kusotere, you are single. God Almighty is going to deliver all of our brethren.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Beware of lies. Beware of coming to celebrate things on social media where you are owing the bank. You're a liar. Some say, God gave me a car. You don't own car. You are paying for it. See, you are finished paying. You don't own car. You are a carless person. God is going to speak the first truth. Hey, Holy Ghost, I give you glory. God Almighty said, all these people are going to wear
shall have their part in the lake which
God said, I especially did a special, what they call apartment. There's a place for them in hell. So, Brother Abel Darina, you are asking Abel, you should be asking Cain. You need Cain in your life to flog you, sir. God Almighty said, we are using Christian fornicator and Christian
believer. Oh, also all liars.
So, God, look at the dogs in Revelation 22:15. Hey, look for the dogs there. Look for dogs in Revelation 22:15.
For without are dogs.
Outside are dogs.
And sorcerers.
Sorcerers.
And whoremongers.
Whoremongers.
And murderers.
Murderers.
And idolaters.
Idolaters.
And whosoever loveth and maketh.
Whosoever. There is only like born again liar. Born again for the catcher. And born again for the catcher. That man needs help. Who is going to help Abel Darina? I don't know how we're going to do this. I wish they can gather some of our daddies like Billy and Connie them. They can gather and go and meet him and help him out. That man is going wacko. God Almighty is going to intervene and deliver these people in the name of Jesus Christ. Are you a Bible believer?
I am
a Bible believer. I'm not going to change from it. I will keep on believing the Bible in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lift your Bible and say, Father, thank you, Lord, for your word. I believe your word. I will stay with your word. I will not be seduced in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's go to God in place of prayer. Lift your voice and give God glory. Where is my brother over there? Where is my sister? Where is my mother? Where is my daddy? Where are my daughters and my sons? Lift your voice to the Lord and thank God. I appreciate God for his word. Lift your voice and give God the glory. And he said, God has come to believe us. We are believers. We are believers. We are believers. Lift your voice and thank God. I appreciate God. Are you a believer? If you are not a believer, you can be a believer today. You can say, Lord, I believe. I believe your word. I believe the Bible. Oh, you are true Bible believer. It is time to stand. Let's ask God for mercy. Father, forgive me. When I did not truly believe, I chose what to believe. Let us repent for the Lord. Let us ask the Lord for mercy. I wish I can help people please. Lift your voice and cry to God. Father, mercy on me. When I did not pray, when I did not stand, I did not believe your word. Have mercy on me. Let us repent for the Lord. I did not believe. I chose what to believe. I chose what to believe. I'm Brethren, you're going to lift your voice to God and cry. You do not even know that you have been seduced already. You don't know. If not for divine intervention, some people would have been seduced out of their marriage. All because of a job. The devil comes in subtle ways. I don't know the dream that you had and the enemy came and weakened you. And you thought it was ordinary. We are going to deal with you on the prayer altar. Father! Demonic suggestion.
Every demonic suggestion.
Against my soul.
Against my soul.
In a dream.
Or
in the physical.
Today.
I resist them.
I resist.
I come against them. Every arrow that came against you with an infection against your faith, against your prayer life, against your evangelism life, against your belief in God, to make you to doubt. Your faith has been shaken. Lift your voice and cry to God. Father, I resist every arrow. I fire my day. I fire my noon. I fire to the night. I came against my soul. I came against my faith. I came against my testimony. Lord, I resist them. It is a two-edged sword. That's a two-edged sword that God used to close the gate of the Garden of Eden. God Almighty is calling you now. He's not to barricade your soul against the seduction of the world, a seduction of preachers, all the seductions all over. If God said it will happen, it will happen. Then there are seducing spirits in the last days. The Lord said it's going to happen. He said many will come and call themselves Christ. Just to seduce people. And there are many. Somebody said many. He said many will be deceived. I will never be there. My family will not be there. You too will not be there. Father, surround me and my family with your ball of fire.
Surround me and my family with
your two-edged sword. Protect our souls. Against the seduction of the world, against the redemption of the world. The Bible says if a man shall wax worse than us, they shall deceive, they shall seduce. But they will not come near me. They will not come near my family. They will not come near my loved ones. In the name of Jesus, they call about the Father, the shadow of God, surround us with your fire. They call about the Father. Family, God Almighty is calling us to begin to stand in the place of prayer. We are fine. We're not going to be looking at the clock. We'll not be limited. Because many of us, the only place where you can really pray, if you want to be sincere, is where you are with fellow brethren.
Yes.
Bible believers that will sharpen ourselves. Rakakala, that is the essence of the gathering.
Father,
every arrow against my prayer life. Your prayer life is your security.
Yes, sir.
Forget about the security of your nation. God Almighty, it is your prayer life. And it's your covering. Nobody is praying for you. Don't be carried away. Father, every arrow against my prayer life, every message from the Queen of the Coast, send up to the message from Jezebel that hindered Elijah from praying. Has spoken. And exactly what the woman said is what he desired. The woman said, the way you killed others, you are going to die. And he said, God killed him. The spirit of death was released. He didn't know. Father, every seductive arrow against my prayer life, against my destiny, from the Queen of the Coast, from the Marine War, Father, today, raise an altar. Lift your voice, and God Almighty answer. For I answer the prayer by fire. Our prayer life will be restored. Our prayer life will be rekindled. Our prayer life will be revived again. Our prayer life, the prayer life of our children, the prayer life of our family altar, it will be rekindled again. It will come alive again.
Where is your Bible? Why don't you carry your Bible close to your chest?
God Almighty is our treasure. It may be hidden in the world. They are lost. I am not lost. Are you lost?
I am lost.
The Lord God Almighty, the word of God is in our hand. We have handled it, child of God. We have seen it. We have touched it. This is God's word. How can I tell you? The letter killed the spirit, giveth life. We are of them that believe the spirit.
of the word of God. The one that was made flesh. The word of God will be made flesh in us. It will be real in our lives. We practice this word. We live this word. When we believe, we see the glory of God. Our eyes will be planted in the glory of the word. Father, fill me with passion. To the word of God.
I
take back the Holy Spirit.
I
refuse to be in error.
I
refuse to walk like an ordinary man.
I
walk in the Spirit.
I walk in the Spirit.
Mighty name we have prayed. Side of God, the Bible says that we that are going through labor suffer reproach because of Jesus Christ, because we believe in the living word. He's coming to save us.
Amen.
God cannot lie. Child of God, why don't you lift your voice and say, Father,
Father,
I believe that word.
I believe that word.
I will not leave you, Lord.
I will not leave you, Lord.
I continue to believe you.
I continue to believe you. Continues in your private closet. Lord
God Almighty said it's time to live like a believer,
yes,
and turn our backs on the deceiver.
Amen.
It's time for us to stick with God.
Yes.
God Almighty said he's counting his precious jewels. And nobody that believes in him will see shame. He said he will see the glory of God.
Amen.
I'm not going to miss that glory.
I'm not going to miss the glory of the Lord.
Because this world can never offer it. God Almighty is going to preserve you and I.
Amen.
All of our family members in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God bless you, family.
Amen.
Keep on praying.
Amen.
Keep on pressing.
Amen.
Jesus tell you, I'm going to see you again on Friday.
Amen.
To be in Nigerian time.
Amen.
Come believing. Come with questions. Come with what is bugging your heart. God Almighty will answer all of our questions.
With
the scriptures.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Love you plenty, plenty.
Amen.
Heaven belongs to us.
Amen.
And we continue to stand for the Lord.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Lift your voice and cry, say, Father.
Father.
In the midst of a crooked and perverted generation,
in the midst of a crooked and perverted generation,
help me to be a true Bible believer. Open your mouth and cry to God. In the midst of a crooked and perverted generation, help me to be a true Bible believer. Lord, and we hold on to your power until you come for us, Lord. Until you come for me, my children. True, a true Bible believer. For your glory, in the name of Jesus. Let your love go so to the Lord. On the Lord's day, on the Lord's day, only true believers shall be. Yes, sir. On the lift your voice and cry to God.